Are we back up? It's always fun when the game crashes, especially that quickly. First match, 2K says, nah. Nah. Not tonight. Well, fuck you, 2K. Bitch. We doing this shit. Dun, dun, dun. Oh, we get to see Brock Lesnar walking across the stream. The screen, rather. Head on over to Universe. Just pick up where we left off, ladies and gentlemen. Episode 279 of Community Universe Mode, and episode 70 of Monday Night Fusion. I could get that dank intro again. Right into the match, and just hopefully this time it does not crash. That'd be nice, 2K. Hey, don't crash for a change. Hey, Yuke's, go to fucking game programming school, why don't you? Just 6 nights off from Point Break, my friends, where these two men, Adam Adams and Bannon, will be joined by Sam Valentine, Rex Carter, Lex Knight, and Samuel Boone to crown a new CMV United States champion, the first in over a year. Of course, there's somebody who would disagree with that fact, and his name is Schmitty, the greatest professional wrestler on the planet, who, of course, calls himself the true CMV United States champion after, at the top of the month, he stole the belt from Johnny Sampson. Claimed himself as being the rightful title holder. Again, remember Samson said that if he participated in the tug of war, Samson would give him something in return, a reward. And although Schmitty did indeed participate and lose, Schmitty still said he didn't say I had to win. He just said I had to participate. So he saw that United States title as a decent enough pay for his participation. As we get a tweet from the Bloody Bear, he says, Houston, we have a problem. CMV having technical difficulties. Better fix it before my match, or revenge is coming. Chris Andrews not too happy with the guys backstage messing up here. A little bit of technical difficulties indeed to kick off Monday Night Fusion, as he's in action later on tonight battling Jaquan Shea. No, George, your guy is on Genesis. This is Monday Night Fusion, so your guy will be competing on Thursdays. Here we go. Try not to jinx it, but let's see if we can finally get into some action. Not the first time that these two will be coming head to head. They fought not too long ago, a couple of months this season. Maybe it was even the first card of this season, the season premiere, that these two went one-on-one with Bannon getting a pretty dominant. It actually wasn't dominant. It was actually a really good match, if I remember correctly. But Bannon did indeed pick up a victory. Adam Adams been red hot since returning at the top of this month. Taking a couple of losses, though, recently. Both these men losing last week. Bannon taking a defeat at the hands of Xander Slate. So both of them looking for that momentum heading into the Armageddon Hell in a Cell. It'll be a first. I think a first for all six. Sam Valentine's never been in one. Rex Carter never. And obviously Lex Snyder. Yeah, so it'll be these six men, all six of them, it'll be their first times putting foot inside of the Hell in a Cell. And it is their chance to become a new United States champion. Do I allow whispers? Well, I can't really deflect them or anything, so you can indeed whisper me. Oh, it's lagging right now, so I can't see. Oh, there we go. Here's a tweet from Paul Devine now, guys. He says, tonight is the night, boys and girls. What could easily be a main event match at any pay-per-view? Me, the living legend, will team up with the insane one to take on Xander and Schmitty. Actually, some news about that, guys. Before the show started tonight, we had a CMB.com exclusive going into the locker room of Schmitty, the self-proclaimed true CMB United States champion. Schmitty saying that he doesn't want to compete tonight. He's feeling a little bit tired, maybe a little bit under the weather. He kind of wants to go home and surprise Laura with an early night. So Schmitty asking his personal interviewer, James, to fill in for him. Schmitty has left the arena, guys. He is no longer here. So tonight, it'll be James and Xander Slate taking on Paul Devine and Justin Sane in the main event. I'm not so sure how Slate feels about that. But indeed, Schmitty is gone. And filling in for him will be James, making his in-ring debut. As here comes the cure of CMB, Bannon, who is the fan favorite to win the Armageddon Hell in a Cell match this Sunday. A poll on the website asked who you're going for, who you'll be putting your money on come Point Break, and four votes for Bannon. I believe in second was Samuel Boone with three votes, and then everybody else got one each. What is up, Little Narwhal Gaming? Welcome to the stream, my friend. James gonna dominate in his debut. Like I said, I don't know how Xander's gonna feel about teaming with James tonight in that big matchup. Xander Slate staring at an undisputed championship shot this Sunday against the champ Justin Sane. And Xander Slate been on nothing but a roll, while lately this past month Justin Sane been on a decline, taking two losses. And that might not sound like a whole lot, but to someone like Justin Sane, who only lost 10 times in all of last season, it's pretty big. Losing twice. Just last week to the man he's teaming with tonight, and Paul Devine. Again, later on tonight, we're going to see Sam Valentine battle Rex Carter. We're also going to see Lex Knight take on Samuel Boone. Got some tag team action coming up after this. Hotline Miami looking to keep their streak alive as they'll battle Party Hard, the former number one contenders to the tag team titles. A win over them could see them put next in line for a shot at Son of Sheik and Shanaz Andoni. Of course, no number one contenders currently announced for them. And much, much more as this match is set to get underway. The referee ringing that bell. Adam Adams and Bannon. It's all about momentum here in this one, folks. Like I said, both men coming off of losses last week. Adam Adams taking the L to Sam Valentine. And Bannon, after a pretty great matchup, was not able to overcome Xander Slate. And Bannon the week prior also taking a loss to Valentine in that false count anywhere match, which was brutal. Surprised Bannon's even still around after being suplexed spine first onto the steel barricade up near the stage over there. But if you're a betting man, certainly you're going to want to look to history. Like I said, last time these two went one-on-one, the season premiere of Monday Night Fusion Season 4 premiere was Bannon who got the victory. It was a very close matchup, though. We'll see if it's as close this time, if Adam Adams can get the victory. Nice counter right there with a Luthez press and a couple of wicked rights. Clobbering away at him. I'm being told we are going to hear from Azrael as well a little later on in the show. He's going to get some screen time to come out here and speak his mind. I'm excited to hear from the Boa, who just picked up his first victory since returning on last week's Reality Wrestling. Maybe hear what's next for him, what he plans in his future. We also got the Fusion debut of Bill Maverick's personal wrecking ball, Gluttony. He takes on Troy Myers, who's been falling into his old jobber-esque way. He's going to try to turn that around tonight. Nice dragon sleeper applied by AA. Bannon going to be able to get out of it there, though. He's going to get an Irish whip to put the cure in the corner from behind. Bannon going to take a launch out with a big old elbow right to the good boy cowboy's jaw. Fisherman driver right there. Damn, that sass from Vivbot. Leg drop from Bannon. Bannon, no stranger to being in a hellish structure. It will be his first time inside the Hell in a Cell, but he did participate in the Elimination Chamber at Exodus, the season finale, not that long ago, just 4 months ago at this point. And here's a tweet from Paul Devine, guys. He says, of course Schmitty has backed out of this match. This is who the GM put all his chips on. This is why high talent like myself get overlooked and swept under the table. Keep running, little man. That savagery from Paul Devine, not happy that Schmitty is ducking him yet again. It's been all month long that Schmitty's been running away from Paul Devine ever since Devine picked up that win over him. The fusion following Validation, and now Schmitty along with Desolation has picked apart every single member of the New Gods. Rhys Matthews currently on the shelf, Mike Crimson currently on the shelf, Sebastian Frost is okay, but he is not here tonight, so Paul Devine really all on his own later on in the main event. Schmitty not apparently going to take advantage of that though, as he has left the building. Nice Shining Wizard Bulldog combo. Little Narwhal, I don't think I did. If you did not join the website, that is heavily advised. You could do !CMV in the chat to get a link, or you can whisper me his hashtags and I'll try to get him that way. But again, joining the site is definitely recommended to keep up with everything. What up, Kenji? Nice counter there by Adam Adams. I do believe he deflected a signature attempt. As he's going to kick off to the midsection. The Cure now with an Irish Whip. Going to put Adams out on the ring apron. And Bannon with a big old crack right to the jaw. What is he planning here? Dear God, what a DDT through the ropes. Absolutely nasty looking. What a pellish. Bannon going to look to get the victory off that. Would not be surprised. This is all she wrote right here, my friends. Oh, just a one count. And here's a tweet from James towards Paul Devine. He says, tonight I'm going to punch you in the mouth for disrespecting the greatest professional wrestler on the planet. Oh my God, Bannon going to do it again. A second one of those devastating DDTs. Holy sh! Are you the guy on YouTube? Then yeah. Indeed, I got all his info, my friend. Though I had some trouble finding him earlier. Hopefully with everything now, I'll be able to get him after the show. Oh, what a clothesline from The Cure, who is absolutely dominating right now. And now Bannon, with a second attempt, going to hoist Adams up onto his shoulders, looking for that half Nelson electric chair. And there it is, the driver going to look to finish off double A. One, two, no! Only a two count, despite all the damage done to the neck and head in this match. Adams stays alive. And now Bannon is going to stare at the good guy Cowboy. I see he's just staring up at the lights. Bannon trying to figure out what he wants to do here, trying to get into the head of Adams, perhaps going to look to finish maybe with the healing touch, perhaps not. Adams grabbing him in a front headlock. Up against the ropes, he goes! Oh my God! Bannon sent flying into orbit there, eliminated from the Royal Rumble as Adams just tossing him clear over the top. Looks like Bannon was going to be going for a clothesline, but to no avail. Referee beginning his count already at three here. These guys got to be careful. Back into the ring slides Adams. Bannon following in suit. Adams going to try to take the advantage there, stomping on his toes. Catches a kick to the midsection. Try to go for that healing touch again. Adam Adams, I believe, going to be shooting for a Sigur Finn. Now look at this. Surprise. Oh. Full Nelson face buster. That's new from Bannon. One, two. Just a two count, though. Wow, that was a sexy move. And now Bannon with Adam Adams rocked. Going to try to take advantage and finish things off here. Goes for the kick to the midsection. Look at the healing touch. Adams, though, clutching it up to counter. And now, what is it? A modified STF here. Going to try to force the Cure to submit. The ropes are right there. I don't know if Bannon's going to be able to get to it. Oh, he's going to be able to break out of it. He's trying to. There he, oh my God, that elbow straight to the face. A nasty DDT, the third one in this match. Going to bust double A wide open. Bannon not happy that his finisher was countered, but trying to stay in the driver's seat. Adam Adams not going down easy, though. Backpack face buster it's looking to be. As he ties the Cure up, slamming him. Let me know how that canvas tastes right there, bruh. Adams. What's Adams going for in the corner? Punt kick. Oh, my God. You won't expect that from the self-proclaimed good guy babyface. Just kicking Bannon's head clean off. One, two, three, and Adams with the win. Holy shit, what a kick. And Adam's going to get that momentum heading into this Sunday's Armageddon Hell in a Cell. What a match. But this time, Adam's going to walk out with the victory as Bannon's starting to build up a little bit of a losing streak. What a kick, though, my friends. I wouldn't be surprised if Bannon's going to be out for the rest of the night. What a way to end this fantastic match off to start Monday Night Fusion. That full Nelson facebuster right there was pretty sweet. And here's where Bannon tried to go for the healing touch. Perhaps if he hit this, he would be walking out the victor. But Adams clutching it up, able to counter. Here's the finish. Look at this kick. My God, if he hits that inside the Armageddon Hell in a Cell this Sunday, we're going to get out our next United States champion, ladies and gentlemen. What a kick. And what a win by the good guy Cowboy. Adams continues his impressive run. Sent his return. Can he walk out of Point Break? The United States champion. And here's a tweet from Rex Carter, ladies and gentlemen, who says, tonight, I'm going to win that United States championship from Sean Valentine, and there ain't nothing anybody going to do about it. So Rex Carter thinking that his match with Sam tonight is for the United States championship, as Sam going to respond here saying, I've seen female football players kick harder. Not impressed. Nobody's going to respond to Rex Carter, but instead commentating on this match. He better get ready to take on Rex Carter a little bit later on tonight. As up next, tag team action set to come our way. That nasty cut there. Adam's got to get that looked at. Sure to be a flamboyant matchup next year on Monday Night Fusion edition number 70. Why did I say it like that? 70. As Party Hard will be taking on the undefeated Hotline Miami. And it looks like we're going to have a guest ringside. Is that Nelson Jr.? Nelson Jr. apparently going to be taking the corner of Eli Richards and Drake Garrett in this matchup. We've seen some tweets these past couple weeks from Nelson saying that Nelson Clan will be arriving soon. Perhaps he's talking about tonight maybe scouting out some potential future partners, or maybe it's already confirmed. We're not too sure, but Hotline Miami looking to keep up their impressive run, currently 3-0, and if they are able to get the win over the former number one contenders in Mac and Maddie here, that could be a big push for them to perhaps put them next in line for a crack at Son of Sheik and Shinaz and Oney and them Fusion Tag Team titles. No number one contenders currently announced, as Party Hard failed to defeat them at Milestone just last Sunday. Or two Sundays ago, rather. As we had a tweet from the Brit now who says, nasty cut. Pfft, watch my matches. I bleed more than Paul Devine at his period. Damn, Britt with some fire towards the Asian sensation. I fire towards everybody. Going to look to put that anger towards Shaquan Shea later on in our co-main event. Of course, Chris Andrews just 6 nights away from his epic rubber match against Zach Cage for the Anarchy title. Actually, a big announcement about that coming on, which we'll get into a little bit later on. We'll get near that match. Main event still to come. It's going to be James, we've now learned, since Schmitty left the arena, and Xander Slate battling Paul Devine and Justin Sane. Can those two work together after just last week? Paul Devine handed Justin Sane only his second loss this season. We are going to find out. We actually heard from the Fusion Tag Team Champions. In fact, before the show, they were talking about this matchup. I believe Shinaz and Oney called them Heatline Bling instead of Hotline Miami, saying that they're actually big fans of them and they wouldn't mind, you know, going at it with them. Kind of rooting for Eli and Drake here. See if Nelson Jr.'s presence ringside will get in the way. Any type of situation here in this one. Mac and Maddie certainly going to get another crack at them tag team titles. There's no sound? What? You can't hear me? Hello? 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 Guys, hear me? Rip. Hello? Hello? You can't hear me? Okay. Alright, then. Topher scaring me there for no reason. Kenji, I saw that tweet, my friend. You're going to have to repost it, though. Too much going on. Missed out on it. You can hear me, though, right? Guys, I just want to confirm. Because Topher's got me worried now. I know Tomcat said he can hear me. I don't know if Echo saying hello was targeted towards me or not, though. Alright, good. Good, good, good. Let's keep the action rolling as Party Hard make their way out here. Mac and Maddie, as I said, trying to keep themselves atop the rankings. After failing to capture the belts from real number one Babas at Milestone 2 weeks ago. Put up a pretty hard fight. Dare I say they were dominating the majority of the matchup. Was a chance comeback by Shanaz Andoni that tapped out, I believe it was Mac, with a camel clutch to retain the titles. If somebody can grab that Kenji tweet for me and repost it so I can read that off. Missed it. Party Hard. Not looking to put over any young talent tonight, as they are still pretty young in their careers. Brought over as a part of the new superstar initiative this season. Oh, but making the CMB Universe wait. Here's that tweet from Kenji Murakami, guys. He says, let me say this. I am one of the pioneers of cruiserweight competitors and competition. If a CW division is to come around, I would love to be the first and its official competitor. A CW, like a heavyweight championship division, certainly on Genesis, which Kenji Murakami is a part of. He actually fell out on the first round of that tournament. It's currently going on, the finals of which will be this Thursday as Salim Ismail will battle King Matt. I guess maybe he's wanting a cruiserweight division, though. As here comes Hotline Miami, not Heatline Bling, as Shanaz Andoni calls them. That's not a bad name either. Eli Richard. Oh, wait a minute, guys. Look on the back of them there. I believe I see Nelson Clan logos on the back of their shirts. So maybe this is hashtag confirmed. Nelson Jr. ringside for them. Could we be looking at the new members of Nelson Clan? I believe so, if evidence proves to be right here. These two young men already beloved by the CMB Universe. I don't know how the fans are going to react to them aligning with someone the likes of Nelson Jr., who's not a big fan favorite. A nasty attitude about him. never really smiling. Nelson Jr. always in a foul mood. I mean, I'm even surprised that he would enlist somebody to be by his side. Such an ego on him. As immediately Mac going to take Eli Richards, I should say, outside Drake Garrett on the ring apron. Topher, can you hear me now? Oh, there's nasty hiccups. Indeed, there is a light heavyweight champion, light heavyweight division, I should say, with a light heavyweight championship on Genesis. That tournament final going to be this Thursday. Salim Ismail battling King Matt. The winner of that will challenge the champ, Nikola Ivanovich, for the belt this Sunday at Point Break on Genesis. We'll also find out who will be challenging Extreme Conditions for the World Tag Team titles, as the Misfits will be taking on King and Company. Nelson Jr. already sticking his nose into this matchup, distracting Mac, but as Eli tries to take advantage. Matt going to counter into a crossbody. Going for the kick to the spine, back to his feet, though, caught with a front headlock. Now taking overhead with a nice T-bone suplex. Tag team action here on Monday Night Fusion. Up next, we're going to see Sam Valentine and Rex Carter going at it. Got Gluttony making his Fusion debut as he will battle Troy Myers. Of course, Lex Knight taking on Samuel Boone. Can Boone keep up that wicked fucking seemingly impossible run he has been on this month? Gotta be one of the biggest explosions onto the scene. Perhaps I'd have to say he'll be a vote for newcomer of the year. I mean, who can say in their first month they beat Xander Slate and Justin Sane and qualified for an Armageddon Hell in a Cell? What if he walks out of Point Break the United States champion? It'd be amazing. And here comes Maddie now, the legal man, as he takes it to Drake Garrett. Gonna get that knee off straight to the face. Party hard. They're certainly flamboyant. Like to dance around, obviously, have a good time, but in that ring, they are very, very vicious. Don't do anything without a purpose. Just get a back body drop there by Drake and a kick to the spine. Gonna miss it though. Maddie able to see it coming and move out of the way. Look at that. Urinage! That's actually a Ura Shelton, I should say. I always get those mixed up for some reason. It's because of that Ura. Garrett away from the ropes with a nice sit-out sidewalk slam there. Gets back to his feet. That main event, of course, tonight, guys, it was supposed to be Schmitty and Xander Slate taking on Paul Devine and Justin Sane. But Schmitty leaving the arena and filling in for him will be his personal interviewer, James, making his debut. No, I want to say John Reed qualifies as a rookie. Because he was here the vast majority of last season. Maybe he'll be on most improved, though, because John Reed's certainly been very impressive this season. He challenges Dragons! John Reed challenging Randy Borton for the International Championship this Sunday at Point Break as Nelson Jr. slides in a steel chair and the referee counting the pin right on it, but not going to toss it out. Big lifting reverse DDT there by Maddie. Nelson Jr. trying to help out Hotline Miami any way that he can right now. Let's get that partyplex from Maddie, who now might be looking to finish as he's going to put Eli in the corner. Makes the tag. Tosses him out. Going to get a double super kick from Party. Oh my God, that looks like Eli kind of landed his neck right on the chair. I'm just going to run circles around him, though, apparently. Referee, please. One. Oh, Nelson Jr. I don't think he had to do that. I'm pretty sure Garrett would have broken it up. He did break it up. And is this going to be enough for the referee to eject him, or did Nelson Jr. pay him off here? And is the ref a part of Nelson clan? As Eli's going to try to take this opportunity to come back. Yes, Nelson Jr. has been ejected. He is out of here. John Cohn is only a Rise fan, apparently. As Richards off the distraction. What the hell is he going for here? Oh my God, electric chair sit out powerbomb. That's going to be a rope break, though. Lucky for the party man and Mac. But Hotline Miami, they had a turnaround like this last week against Warriors Justice. Puts him in the corner. Going to look for Grand Amplitude to finish things off here. Matt could be in big, big trouble. The catapult catches him with a nasty back suplex. Gonna stop Maddie from making the save. Oh, but Matt clutching it up to kick out. And now Maddie trying to come over and help out Matt. Gonna go for the pin again. Eli just broke it up, though. He's saying, no, man, don't even bother. That's not gonna be enough. We gotta keep working on this guy. This tag team match continues. Nelson Jr. nearly costing Party Hard the matchup, but he very well may still, because Mac is not looking too good, just as I say that. He's going to get back to his feet. Oh, and here's another partyplex, this time to Drake with the hands of Mac. Nelson Jr. has been ejected from ringside as Mac with a beat of the chest, letting out a mighty roar. Wasting too much time, though. That's allowing Garrett to try and get to his feet here. He's almost there on his knees. Springs out with an elbow. Making a quick tag to Richards. And Richards immediately with an Irish whip to put Mack in the corner. What is Eli looking for here? We're not going to find out. Catches him with a nasty-looking DDT. He gets put in that corner, eats a second double superkick. I don't think Drake's going to be able to save him. And a springboard moonsault, but Mack moving out of the way. Uh-oh, puts him in the corner. Could we see Hotline Miami handed their first loss here tonight? It's looking like it. Double superkick again to Richards. No steel chair to land on this time, but still pretty nasty. Looks like Garrett's going to be able to break that up, though, and he does at the Klaus count of two there, Klaus. Still to come tonight, guys, in our co-main event, Jaquan Shea going to take on the Anarchy champion, Chris Andrews. The Bloody Brit is just 6 nights away from that epic rubber match for the title against Zach Cage, and a big announcement about that matchup at Point Break. We're going to hear a little bit later on tonight. As Matty trying to fight his way out of the corner of Hotline Miami. Caught with a nice hammer lock back suplex right there, though. Jawbreaker. Matty going to stagger Eli. Shoots in. Going to take the opportunity with another party plex. Lifts him up. Oh, my God. He takes a third double super kick. Oh, no. Eli counters. Clutching it up, realizing he's in big trouble. Oh, but now he's going to get taken to Dickplex City, ladies and gentlemen. Many superstars taken there before. They never come back the same. And there's the third one. As Eli Richards is hurting for certain. Perhaps Matty going to look to finish. Yes, he is. Going to look to finish it off with just one super kick instead of two. It's the party kick, ladies and gentlemen. Bah, no, Eli. With the clutch of the century, Alvius. We haven't had Big Al in here in a good while. He's just in time to see Eli get off a beautiful handspring cutter, which could be the end of this tag team encounter. One, two, no. Matty able to kick out there as Trey Garrett missed spearing Mack off of the apron anyhow. Gonna back up into the midsection. Nice bulldog there by Matty. Gonna bust Eli wide open. His first taste of blood here in CMB. Hotline Miami since debuting at the top of the month. Knocking off the Domestic Wolves, the Hooligans, and just last week, Warriors Justice. A win over Party Hard here tonight. Could certainly see them as the new number one contenders. And get a crack at the real number one Bubba. As we heard from Shanaz and Tony earlier tonight, he said he'd love to face Heatline Bling, as he called them. But Party Hard certainly not going to put over any of that young talent as we get. Oh, no. What's he going for this time? Mack with that lift and cutter, I do believe. We see him and Matty hit from time to time. And Eli has taken a lot of damage. He has got to make a tag to Drake Garrett. Going to get the opening. Dragon Scott! Not going to take that opportunity to make the tag, though. What is Matt going for here? Cross arm neck breaker. Going to hop right into the pin. Could he steal it? One, two, just a two count. Eli remaining resilient, but he has got to make a tag. He does not look good. He's bleeding. He's bruised. He's tired. He's taken two double super kicks, like four party plexes at this point. It is not looking good. And now just going to stare at Richards. Is Matt here from the corner? Waiting for him to get up, perhaps, but that was a mistake as Eli gonna put him in the corner. Approaching him slowly, he's not stupid. He may be new to CMV here, but he is not dumb. He's gonna triangle drop kick, sends Mack tumbling down to the outside. Now gonna take that opening to tag in Drake Garrett. Very, very smart. And here comes the fresh Garrett now. Gonna go to the outside to retrieve his opponent. Or what is he doing? Oh, I thought he was going to maybe try for a an apron dive or something, but changed his mind, decided to play it safe. I don't know what Maddie's doing. He's just jumping on and off the apron now. Doesn't want to get involved, but trying to distract Drake maybe. Toss back into the ring. Drake trying to recuperate. Going to take a big overhand punch. No, Drake saw it coming, able to counter with an elbow right to the face. And now middle of the ring, Drake Garrett, the powerhouse of Hotline Miami, drops down behind us. Back though with a nice Russian leg sweep to counter. And here's a tweet, ladies and gentlemen, from Schmitty. He says, "Don't worry, Sushi. It's been confirmed that we'll face off at Point Break. Your beating can wait." Ladies and gentlemen, Schmitty just making this announcement here on Twitter. This Sunday has been confirmed. Schmitty one-on-one with Paul Devine in a rematch. Oh, my God. That DDT, ripped Drake Garrett. Holy shit. And now Matt gonna put him in the corner with eyes to finish, looking for that double super kick. What up, Terrence? Oh, no, went for a punch instead. Drake Garrett somehow still alive after that clearly botched DDT. Keeps trying to make the tag, but Garrett's just simply having none of it. Now what is he gonna do here to Drake? Pointing at the turnbuckle. Big power slam, and then just drops him down onto the canvas. Garrett's hurting. No doubt about it, after his neck was just snapped in two. Gonna try to finish here though, with a second dose of Grand Amplitude. Matt kicked out of one earlier. I don't know if he's gonna be able to manage two. Ref, you're not gonna count it. Ref. Ref's having none of it. He says, nah. I was yelling at him. Oh, he's going to try again, though, is Eli. Ref's going to count this time. One, two. No, but Matt kicks out. That was a good 20 count there off the second Grand Amplitude. But I don't know. John Cohn just decided he doesn't really want to get down on the mat right now. I'm going to put him in the corner. Party hard. Going to try to bounce back now. I fucking hate this game sometimes. Eli Richards in to take a third double super kick. Into the pin goes Matty. One, two, three. And Drake Garrett not even getting in the ring to break up the pin there. He was so distressed that John Cohn just cost them that match. Because Hotline Miami most definitely would have won. But John Cohn screwing them, perhaps getting some revenge for Nelson Jr. pulling him out of the ring earlier. And Party Hard going to hand Hotline Miami their first loss because of it. Off of that third double super kick to poor Eli. Wow, hashtag screw job, man. I do echo, but I believe Moore is going to promoize them. And Party Hard gonna put down the newcomers after they were screwed by John Cohn here tonight. If you would like to join the show, Terrence, all you have to do is hit !CMB! !Join in the chat and get a link to our website. Sign up there, post your call on the wait list, and I will download them as soon as I can. And that's what did it in a third double super kick. Going to get Party Hard the win. I believe we're going to need a rematch between these two teams because that was bullshit. John Cohn refusing to count the pin off that second Grand Amplitude, which obviously would have meant the win. But nonetheless, it is Mac and Matty who walk out the victors here tonight, keeping themselves alive in talks of a possible title opportunity. I said CMB, my friend. Well, Tomcat just posted it for you right there. It's !CMB! !Join. You see the link right there. Just follow those simple steps. You can become a part of the show. Ooh, Hotline Miami. I think Eli might be a light heavyweight. Drake Garrett's definitely not. He's the powerhouse of that duo. As up next, more singles action to come. Going to be singles action from here on out until our main event, where James, in place of Schmitty, teams with Xander Slate to take on Paul Devine and Justin Sane. Kicking off the show, though, we saw Bannon put down Adam Adams. Now it's time for Lex Knight and Samuel Boone to go at it. Two of the six men who will step into hell this Sunday. The devil's favorite structure for a chance to become the new CMB United States champion. Later on, we see Sam Valentine and Rex Carter go at it as well. That co-main event, Jaquan Shane, Chris Andrews, with the debut of Gluttony, battling Troy Myers. I think that's on after this one. As I was just talking about in that last matchup, though, Samuel Boone, perhaps going to be a nominee for Newcomer of the Year. Most definitely, if he actually manages to walk out of Point Break, the United States champion, most definitely he'll be a nominee. And I wouldn't be surprised if he won it with his first month here. He's beaten Xander Slate clean. He beat Just Insane clean. This guy, Samuel Boone, in his third match, beat Just Insane in the main event of Monday Night Fusion. And then beating both Azrael and Sean Kent to qualify for the Armageddon Hell in a Cell. I mean, this guy's just on a whole nother level. I don't understand where he came from, what he's doing, but I want to know about it. I want him to share his tips with me because I certainly got to get on that. Lex Knight, of course, been on a roll himself, qualified for the Armageddon Hell in a Cell by defeating Crow last week. Also picked up a win over Azrael a couple of weeks back. Lex Knight saying he's going to walk out of Point Break, the CMB United States champion. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Who isn't a Gibson fan, though? Me, I'm not. Sorry, Borton. This Sunday, ladies and gentlemen, Point Break. Not only will that Armageddon Hell in a Cell descend upon the ring, we've also got Just Insane defending his world title against Xander Slate, just announced by Schmitty himself on Twitter. He'll be battling Paul Devine in a rematch. I'm very much looking forward to that. Of course, the Alpha World title to be decided. Bob Luger and Furious Frank. And it has been announced that they will go at it for the title inside of the Hell in a Cell. And much, much more. As here he comes, the one and only. Samuel Boone. If he beats Xander Slate, Just Insane, and fucking Azjon Sean Kent, then comes out here and loses to Lex Knight. Nothing against Lex Knight, but Lex is a young blood himself. He's new, only been here about a month and a half. It would just. I don't know. I wouldn't know how to explain it. But we'll see what happens. Anything can happen in CMB. One of these men gonna walk into Point Break with the momentum. Well, it's the Armageddon Hell in a Cell, which of course will feature these two men, Lex Knight and Samuel Boone, joined by Adam Adams, Bannon, and then Sam Valentine, Rex Carter, who will go one-on-one a little bit later on tonight. And then it has been announced that Bob Luger and Furious Frank's matchup for the Alpha World title will be inside of Hell in a Cell. Again, that big announcement still to come regarding Chris Andrews and Zach Cage's rubber match at Point Break for the Anarchy title still to come our way. Samuel Boone is owned by Master Ogon, who was here for a while last season. He came back like a month ago and then hasn't been back since. Gonna try to make Samuel Boone a jobber, but you know he's just fighting against it. Samuel Boone saying, "No way. You know what? You're gonna pay me, and I'm gonna win. I'm gonna beat all your main eventers. F you." Samuel Boone, a fucking monster, a beast from a goddamn another planet. Like I said, he needs to share what his training regimen's like or something. Now that you're signed up, Terrence, you go to the waiting list, which is located inside of the roster section. And then all you got to do is post your cause name, his hashtags, which if you haven't uploaded him yet, please upload him with hashtag CMV so I can find him easier. But if he's already uploaded, just provide the hashtags and then tell us about him if you want to. That's not required, though. Lex Knight starting strong here against Samuel Boone. Nice hip to the spine. And a second time, one's not enough. Perhaps I'm going to try for a third. Now I'm going to grab him by that afro instead, and that is a big mistake. Dragon! Scatter! As Boone going to stomp down onto his face, Samuel got Lex Knight trapped. He's in the jaw of a gator. Now to that front face lock, and a let go of it. They're trying to wear down Lex a little bit. Also to come, guys, a little bit later on, we're going to be hearing from Azrael. The Boa has got something to say regarding his future. Eager to hear what he's going to have to say out here in front of the CMB universe. Lifting Lex Knight up by his tights, high into the air, and back down again with a reverse DDT. Excuse me, that hiccup right there. Boo now. Going to scale to the top rope, take a risk. Will it pay off? Yes, it will. The Houston hangover, the Irish hangover. The move that Quinn Bell in her year career here in Fusion only hit like two or three times. Samuel Boone, first try, going to hit it. Point Break is this Sunday, Maury. This Sunday, just six nights away. Of course, we got Thursday Night Genesis a little bit later on in the week. A couple of big matches. Excited for that card. And then Reality Wrestling, edition number four. And then Point Break is on Sunday as we get a pin here on Samuel Boone. Not even a one count, though. Boone not having any of that. Goes for an overhand punch. Samuel Boone going to fight it, though. Snapmare by Lex. Going to go for that afro again. Got a neck crank cinched in. Boone trying to battle back to his feet. Big old hook to the midsection. Going to hunch him over in pain. And boom, and a shining wizard. A devastating maneuver. Knee right to the side of the head. Oh, now sizing him up. Looking for that Tiger Bomb, which he beat Xander Slate and Justin Sane with the Lex Knight. Going to clutch it up and save himself. Now big kick to the spine. Knight going to try to turn things around here. And hand Samuel Boone his first loss on Monday Night Fusion. Nightfall connects. Could he get the win here? Hooks the leg. One, two. No, Samuel Boone going to power out. Lex Knight not happy about that. More so confused as to how Boone was able to power out of that. Boone looking up at the lights now. Lex Knight going to try to stay in control, stomping him right down on his face. And the Dragon Sky! Once again. Into an aggressive pin attempt. One. Not even a one count. Or just a one count, rather. Not even a two count. Lex Knight in that interview last week after his win over Crow, saying, "You might look at me, say there's a guy with stars on his tights, you know, purple hair, and take me as a joke. But I am not to be taken lightly. And I will be the one walking out of Point Break with that United States Championship over my shoulder." We've seen dark horses win big matches before. The first ever CMB Armageddon Hell in a Cell, ladies and gentlemen, was won by Omega Z. And Omega Z was a rookie at the time. Not even a month, I don't think, into his career. He's got a big old discus, big boot out of the corner. Big old big boot by Lex Knight there. The second ever Armageddon Hell in a Cell was won by Caden Kenra. That was at the second annual SummerSlam. I do believe it's going to go for another Nightfall, but this time Sammy Boone scouts it out, able to counter it. And the most recent Armageddon Hell in a Cell was won by Fury last year. And the Vixens went at it for the championship. Oh, slingshot leg drop attempted. Lex Knight going to force Boone to land right on his tailbone, though, as now he puts him into the corner. These two acting like they know each other very well. Up top goes Boone. Excuse me there. Samuel Boone going to counter, take a risk off the top rope. Will it pay off? Yes, it will. A cannonball using his own body as a weapon, just hurling himself at Lex Knight. Now he goes to the second turnbuckle. Going to send him a sweet kiss. Good night, Lex Knight, though. Taking that time that Boone wasted the taunt. Able to move out of the way. Now going to stomp down onto the quad. Boone trying to crawl away. Overhand punch and next Irish whip. Now going to put Boone in the corner. Lex Knight going to try to put him on top again, perhaps. No, Irish whip to the opposite side of the ring. Going to charge him full force with a body splash. Grabbing him by that afro. Lex Knight, we've seen him hit this before. This is actually what he beat at Crow with last week to qualify for the Armageddon Hell in a Cell. Electric chair, sit-out powerbomb. One, two, just a two count, though. Boom, eating everything. He's eating that powerbomb. He ate a discus, big boot. He ate Nightfall. Just kicking out of everything, though. Lex Knight trying to get the CMB Universe behind him as he shoots the finish again, but Boone back to his feet. What do you mean it won't let you, Terrence? grabbing him by that purple hair. Gonna go for a second. Shining Wizard. Lex Knight, though, able to deflect it. Takes him overhead with a fireman's carry. Counter after counter after counter after counter. Reversal after reversal. Tip for tat. Maurice, 1999 up in here. Oh, my God, ladies and gentlemen. Are we going to see a British drive-by? I think we might. But Lex ain't British, my friends, here in Houston, Texas. He just put both boots right to Samuel Boone's temple. Straight into the pin as quick as he can. One, two, three. And Lex Knight going to put down Boone. As we get a tweet from Jamari Williams, he says, next week following Point Break, the newest episode of the Sneak Peek will include multiple-time title contender Sam Valentine. That's going to be exciting. Perhaps Sam will be the United States champion come next week. We'll have to wait and see. As Lex Knight picks up the victory over Samuel Boone, ladies and gentlemen, putting an end to his run of terror. Now there's only one match left to go. Later on, Sam Valentine battles Rex Carter in the final ploy for momentum heading into the Armageddon Hell in a Cell. What a matchup between these two, though. They tore the blew the roof off this place. Tore the walls down. I'm not your dad, Maury. Please chill. And here's the finish. Double boots put to the temple. A British drive-by. Let's see if Chris Andrews tries to show him how it's really done later on against Shaquan Shea. One, two, Trey. And Lex Knight continues his impressive streak. Can he keep it up? Will he walk out of Point Break the new United States champion? We'll find out this Sunday. Britt gonna try and kick off Jaquan's head and fucking go to prison. Up next, folks, it is time to see the fusion debut of Bill Maverick's personal wrecking ball, a new member of the Unholy Alliance in Gluttony, as he battles the self-proclaimed ultimate jobber, but no more. Remember, Troy Myers discarded his t-shirt. He threw all that away, put it behind him, because this season's been on quite the tear. He beat Billy Weaver, essentially retired Billy Weaver, at least for the foreseeable future. Weaver not been seen since that loss. He beat Bannon. He's been winning nonstop, but lately been on a little bit of a decline. He lost that fatal four-way. He also lost to newcomer Michael Barker last week. He's going to try to turn that around here tonight, lest he become the ultimate jobber once again. Ah, what is that? Cranberry. Fucking kill me now. I thought that was fruit punch. Jesus Christ. Fucking. Ugh. Hate cranberry. Fucking rip. He's a big Baldy fan now. He, you know, ever since getting his hair shaved off, losing that hair match against Jay Davis way back when, he just likes the look. I just shaved my head, actually, recently. Just last night, I fucking shaved my head, even. I'm a big Troy Myers fan. I wanted to emanate my idol, you know? I believe that one day Troy Myers could be the undisputed champion. You heard it here, folks. But he's certainly got quite the obstacle in his way tonight. Oversized, no doubt about that. The 400-pound gluttony. And you got Bill Maverick ringside as well, short of medal in this one. You can't even see it, Batman. I got a hat on my profile picture. I look hot as fuck. And Ralph chilling. Get all the ladies, fam. Ah, here he comes. The 400-pound wrecking ball. That is Gluttony, the newest member of the Unholy Alliance, looking to do his boss, his mentor, his leader, Bill Maverick proud here tonight. You can just whisper me the hashtags, Terrence, at this point if you're having too much trouble, my friend. Like I said, if you haven't uploaded them yet, upload with hashtag CMV. I'd appreciate it so I can find them quick. Gluttony, ready to make his Fusion debut. Of course, isn't his debut period. He actually made his first on-screen appearance a couple of weeks ago on a live event where he actually won via disqualification against Razor Windu. Windu hit him with a sledgehammer. I know, cop copying me. I did CMV fucking XCOM first. You heard it here, all right? Cop, you fucking thief. No, I don't really care, but I did do it first. You remember that. Can't wait for Tops Newsome to die immediately as soon as he steps off the ship. The first mission cop list. As here comes Troy Myers. You guys ever watch World War Z, where that scientist guy runs off the plane, slips, and shoots himself in the head? That's gonna be Tops Newsome. That's what he's gonna do. He's gonna run down the ramp, slip, and shoot himself in the head. Hashtag confirmed. And here we go. Singles action to come. The next pay-per-view, or special event, rather, after Point Break, which is a Sunday, will be Dark Carnival returning for October, which is CMB time. And then following that will be Regicide, the second annual Regicide, of course, where every single title in CMB will be on the line. It'll be 8 championship matches you're not going to want to miss. Let's get a DDT right out of the gate by Troy Myers. Big old lariat by Gluttony to fire back. That was Bill Maverick very happy ringside thus far. Battle of the Chrome Domes here. Troy Myers loops. What are you going to look like in like 10 years? There's no real gimmick to Point Break. There's 2 Hell in a Cell matches, but it's not a Hell in a Cell gimmick pay-per-view, really. I guess the Armageddon Hell in a Cell is really the gimmick of it. Because we have one of those every year. This will be the 4th one coming this Sunday. Oh, what a headbutt to connect. Troy Myers getting mollywhopped right now. Got to turn things around quickly, and he does with that jawbreaker. Gonna charge, goes for a knee tremble, I believe, though. Maybe a big one. Can't really tell from that angle. But did not take him off his feet. Now an inverted atomic drop. Still, oh, and then a clothesline. Still not off his feet. Jesus Christ, Gluttony cannot be toppled here. Troy Myers trying everything. Look at this full Nelson face busters. Now finally, he drops down into the corner. Going for a stomp, but immediately springs back to life. Gluttony going to attempt a... Oh, holy powerbomb, dear God. Holy shit. Just nearly decapitated him on the top rope there. Puts him up to his feet. Troy Myers, Irish whip, out onto the apron. He goes, dropping down to the outside. Bill Maverick helping out his personal wrecking ball. Troy Myers telling Fear to fucking beat it. As the referee begins his count, Maverick certainly got to be careful not to risk a DQ here. Gluttony winning by DQ again. Big old lariat there as he pulls him back. Like Gluttony's got that gravitational pull. The referee is currently at a count of 3 here. Topher, where's that new banner though, kid? No, I don't really care. Cop was the one who was freaking out about it. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Bill Maverick technically not interfering, ladies and gentlemen. He's not touching Troy Myers. Myers has touched him. Tell him to get the fuck out of here. Referee's at a count of, I think, 7. As Gluttony rolled back to the ring, Myers following in suit. Grabbing him by the head, by his ears, really. Oh, shit. Troy Turner, no! Gluttony reverses another clobbering forearm. And now Glenny, no, dear God, 400-pound ass right in Troy Meyer's face, and Gluttony ain't even done yet. What is he cooking up here? Goes for kicks to the midsection, no! Troy Meyer ain't letting it happen. Turns him over into a Boston Crab, looking for the submission. Oh, but Gluttony quick to get out of it. Snapmare there. Puts Troy Meyer in a seated position. Gluttony going to work with a neck crank. Lateral press attempt at 400 pounds, bearing down to the chest. Myers, though, able to power out of it just to count a one. Stomping down to the back of that chrome dome. As Gluttony now to the second turnbuckle. Body splash. Myers doesn't have none of that. Don't talk ill of Papa John's Echo, please. All right, Papa's the best. Bless him and all his glory, his sody pops, okay? Oh, no, another fucking shit. Oh, alley-oop bomb. He just hit like every single turnbuckle on the way down. Doink, doink, doink. Now a lateral press. One, just a one count. A dominant, all the muscles he's really showing off there. Might call him the human wrecking ball, but pure flab, I do believe, here on Gluttony. You just tell by his name there. Bill Maverick watching on. Troy Meyer taking some time to talk to the CMB Universe. As Troy takes a step back, allowing Gluttony to get to his feet. What is he cooking up here? Well, we're not going to find out. Took too much time, and now Gluttony with a Samoan drop. Gluttony, perhaps another time, going to go for that butt slap. No, Troy Meyer breaks free of his grasp. I got there. Oh, oh, shit, kill switch. Kill switch out of nowhere by Troy. Holy shit. One, two, three, and Troy Meyer with the win. Holy fuck. What a comeback. Clutching it up. Troy Meyer with the kill switch out of nowhere to get the win over Gluttony here tonight live on Monday Night Fusion. Wow. That was a bit of a shocker. Troy Meyer with the kill switch literally out of thin air to take down Gluttony here tonight. Look at that, though. Dear fucking God, he hit every single turnbuckle on the way down. Duh, duh, duh. Just killed him. And here's the finish. Kill switch gonna catch Gluttony off guard. And secure Meyer the three count and the victory here tonight. Troy Meyer proving that he indeed ain't no jobber no more. Instead, he's the one putting down that young talent. Gluttony certainly putting up one hell of a fight, dominating the majority of that matchup, but Meyer, like he usually does, slaying another giant. Pretty much killed Billy and absorbed his moniker before Billy took his current vacation. Remember, towards the end of last season, he beat like all the giants. When he beat Grid, he beat Headhunter. Just beating them all, just racking up them victories. And now that is Troy at Miles' game. As we head into the next matchup of the evening, the final of the Armageddon Hell in a Cell match collisions here. as the Dream Sam Valentine will go up against the Hillbilly Rex Carter. Of course, you see they're flanked by his clients, the real number one Bubba's Baby, Son of Sheik and Shanaz and Andone, the Fusion Tag Team Champions. So far tonight, kicking off the show, we saw Adam Adams get a win over Bannon, and then Lex Knight putting down Samuel Boone, who's going to walk out with momentum here. And this one, as the Devil's Favorite Structure awaits this Sunday at Point Break to crown a new United States champion. Again, that poll on CommunityUniverse.4motion.com asked the CM Universe who they would be betting on come the pay-per-view, and Bannon in the lead, close behind Samuel Boone and everybody else averaging out, tied. Sam Valentine nearly didn't get any votes. Someone at the last second slipped in there to put their hat in the corner of old Valentine. Who I would say out of the current lot, me personally, just looking at this past month, would be my number one pick. Seeing as how he's beaten three of the men inside the Armageddon Hell in a Cell. Or two, rather. He's beaten Adam Adams just last week, and then he beat Bannon the week prior. Could make it three here tonight as he takes on Rex Carter. Still to come, though, following this, guys, we're going to hear from Azrael coming out to the ring, getting a little bit of screen time. Going to tell us what's on his mind. I'm excited to hear what he has to say. Then we got the co-main event, Jaquan Shea battling the Anarchy champion, Chris Andrews. That main event, James making his in-ring debut, filling in for Schmitty as he teams with Xander Slate to battle Paul Devine and Justin Sane. I got you, Topher. You look so good to me. I got you. Let's get this match underway. We just heard a while ago Jamari Williams tweeting out that Sam Valentine will be his guest on next week's edition of the Sneak Peek. The question is, will Valentine be the United States champion during that interview? Jamari was not wrong in saying Valentine, a multi-time contender, mostly for the tag team belts in his tenure alongside Lance Romance and the Bromance, where he really came to fame. Became a fan favorite, broke off. The two got drafted to separate brands during the split. That's when Valentine really began to shine on his own, beating Justin Sane, getting inside the Elimination Chamber. He was in the final two, of course, which was won by Chris Andrews in the end. Mari, that was Billy and Chuck's theme before it was Eve's, all right? Valentine certainly got one of those attitudes that make him very hard to be in the same room with. His ego just about as inflated as this entire arena is tonight. No doubt in his mind, I can assure you that much, that he'll be walking out this Sunday, the United States champion. And Shanaz Andone standing in front of him. The Hillbilly, Rex Carter, baby. Listen to this pop he's getting here tonight. As he is indeed enjoined by Johnny Gat, the Bujabi playboy, Shanaz Andone Baloney. And a Son of Sheik, I don't know where he is. He hasn't come out here yet. The Fusion Tag Team Champions in tow, though. He is their manager, usually in their corner, but they're here for him tonight. There's Son of Sheik, leaving their titles in the back. Of course, CMB were known to have titles stolen every now and then, so it's a safe bet. With Party Hard getting that win earlier tonight over Hotline Miami, perhaps they're going to get another crack at the belt. Perhaps they're next in line for another shot. Maury, please learn to read. It says the man who brought you Chef Taylor. Thank you. Here we go. Referee rings the bell as Sam Valentine and Rex Carter are set to get it on. And Carter right out of the gate shades of his former tag team partner Xander Slate with that spine buster. Xander Slate in action. Tonight's a main event. Teaming with James. Like, still can't get over that. James. If I were Xander Slate, I would be fucking fuming. As they'll take on Paul Devine and Justin Sane. Don't tell me what to fucking do, Batman. I'm sure that the real number one Bubba's ringside won't be of any interference tonight. Just given that emotional support for Rex here. Rex forgets that he's even, you know, associated with them most of the time. In fact, he just forgot earlier as he was talking to them. Mid-sentence, he said, "Who are you?" Rex Carter, though, saying that he wasn't able to get enough moonshine in him tonight. Yeah, actually, asked Shanaz to go out and buy him a six-pack, but instead, Shanaz, what did Shanaz get him again? He got him something stupid, like, I don't know, like a rug or something like that. Rex Carter wasn't too happy, so I don't think Rex Carter's actually drunk right now. He might be even sober, which is something we rarely see. How about that modified stunner by Valentine, though? What up, Noah? Welcome, my friend. Bit late. Still got some action to come, though. The co-main event, the main event itself, and then, as always, that live event. Pretty good live event, but do say so myself as well. Miss Valentine dominating early on. Rex Carter, though, going to fling him off. Off the ropes he goes. Catches him on the rebound. Spins him. Trying to make him a little bit dizzy if he is drunk. Maybe going to try to throw him up. Flips him over, shoots the half. Does Valentine, son of Sheik, getting a better position here? His jacket's freaking out a little bit. Adams has indeed had his match. It was the first match of the evening. If you don't want it spoiled, then I won't spoil it for you. I can't promise the chat won't, though. As Rex Carter lifted up to a seated position by his mullet, and a big old soccer ball kick straight to the spine. Dropkick to the back of the neck now. Valentine just dominating thus far. Rex Carter has not been able to get going at all. Every corner, Valentine's there to meet him, shutting his shit down from coast to coast. That dominant display we see from him since his return. Oh, gonna go for those rapid kicks. There we go. A clutch counter by Rex might finally be the turnaround he needs. And a big old lariat. Remember, Valentine was put on the shelf for 7 weeks after the season finale of Exodus. In that elimination chamber, he had suffered a slight neck injury. Upon his return, blamed. Oh, go for that hillbilly boot! But Valentine just hopping out of the way. Gonna go for those kicks again. This time they're gonna connect over and over and over and over and over again. Rex's ribs gotta be hurting for certain right now, but Sam Valentine not looking to stop. Oh, Rex, with whatever he has left, pushing him off. And look at Son of Sheik! Wow, I didn't think they'd get involved, but Son of Sheik gonna help out the hillbilly here a little bit. Calling Valentine's attention. Son of Sheik just yelled, "Nightclubs are for fucking faggots." Sam Valentine was not happy about that. He heard that, he just got fucking steam blown out of his ears. Rex Carter, though, immediately put down back to the canvas. Russian leg sweep there at the hands of the Dream. Though I feel like Son of Sheik may frequent clubs, nightclubs, and likes as well. Oh, here we go! No, shit! Valentine trying for that stop that sets up the Dream Shatterer. Having none of it, though, is Rex, as Carter sizing him up. Looking for the Rex Flex. What an upset this would be, though! Finisher counters left and right, every which way, up and down, tip for tap. Maury, what is it, 1999 up in here or something? As now we got a corkscrew neck breaker by the Dream. Where's Lance, pussy? Go back to the tag team division, you bitch. Oh, here we go. This ballad of kicks right to the chest again. That's gonna be a look at Shanaz praying for Rex. He's like, dear fucking God, please save my friend. He is dying right now. Was gonna full Nelson slam by the hillbilly. Son of Sheik again asking questions. Can we go and party with you guys after? And now look at Son of Sheik messing with the top turnbuckle. What a dirty fucking heel he's been in this match. Shanaz and Odie, the good little Christian boy over there fucking praying for Rex Carter's safety and shit. And Son of Sheik just being a motherfucker as Sam Valentine. This time gonna get it off. What up, 702? Just in time to perhaps see the finish as Valentine. Double boots to the ribs. Gonna finish him off. Into the pin. Oh my God. Son of Sheik again gonna interfere here. When's the ref gonna toss him out, man? Perhaps that's where all... No, Son of Sheik is gone! I don't know if that means Shanaz is gone as well, but Son of Sheik most definitely is out of here. He has been ejected from ringside. I guess we'll see if Shanaz goes with him. I can't even see Shanaz this cow. Yep, Shanaz is going with him, ladies. Oh no, Shanaz taking his place! Now Shanaz is in his corner. Son of Sheik is gone, but the ref allowing the real number one Bubba himself, the Punjabi playboy Johnny Gett, to stay here. It's Rex Carter trying to stay on top of things. Before Shanaz starts interfering now, goes for a snapmare. Sam throwing him off. That took all out of him, though. He's tired. He's beaten down. He's been dominating. Putting that work in, and it's drained the tank here as Rex Carter rallying the CM Universe behind him as the hillbilly gonna fly. Double axe handle takes him down. And a pound to the chest. Rex Carter is riding high right now. Stomp down onto the chest. Takes a big kick to the spine. String it together, a nice little combo. Now what the hell is he going for? The DDT! El Jefe actually does have an injury. I got that medical report after last week's Genesis. And there's the hillbilly boot, the second time's the charm as Sam Valentine gonna taste his own blood, maybe swallowed a couple of his own teeth as well. Right back to his feet though, not letting it deter him as he goes for the kick. Alabata Dragon Scrib! Rex Carter not letting his momentum slow. Valentine going for a knee. These two are just dodging each other left and right. Jesus Christ, German suplex. Oh, now Rex Carter gonna give it one more go. Rexplex! And Shanaz and Oni absolutely thrilled, hopping up and down. What a win this would be for Rex Carter. One, two, three, and he got it! Rex Carter just pinned Sam Valentine. Shanaz can't believe it. And that is thanks in large part to the distractions caused by Son of Sheik. You gotta think that Valentine probably would have won off that Shattered Dreams, but Sheik interfering, the referee ejecting him. Shanaz didn't interfere, but Rex Carter, though, with the Rexplex gets the win. Look at Shanaz's reaction, says it all. He can't believe Rex won. What a match, though. Here's the finish. Rexplex. And here's a tweet from the Bloody Bear who says, nice, a guy who can drink and win. Reminds me of, well, me. There was the finish. What a win for the hillbilly. Could we be looking at our next? Well, actually, that tweet from Rex earlier, he seemed to think that this match was for the United States Championship. So perhaps Rex thinks he's already won the belt, but he could actually win it for real in reality this Sunday. That Armageddon Hell in a Cell, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be joined by, of course, Sam Valentine, Lex Knight, Samuel Boone, Adam Adams, and Bannon. Here we go. Up next, a short break from the action. It's been a great episode thus far. I have to say, match of the night was probably Lex Knight, Samuel Boone. Of course, we still got a great matchup. And our co-main event to come, Shaquan Shea taking on Chris Andrews, the Anarchy Champion. A big opportunity for JS. But, of course, Chris Andrews needs that sweet, sweet momentum heading into his epic rubber match against Zach Cage for the title. And that big announcement to come as that match is getting underway. Main event, of course, substituting for Schmitty, who's left the arena, didn't feel like competing tonight. Going to be his personal interviewer, James, making his debut as he teams with what is sure to be a pissed-off Xander Slate to take on Paul Devine and Justin Sane. Here we go. Let's see what the boa, let's see what Big Asshole has got to say here, ladies and gentlemen. Excuse me. I'm getting a little bit of sniffles. Here we go. Hey, Sean Kent, you might want to listen to what I have to say. I've got a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for you if you're willing to come down to this ring and join me. Be careful back there. Don't hurt yourself rushing out, but don't take your time either. Asriel calling out the man that he teamed with last week on Reality Wrestling to get his first win since returning. They beat the team of Crow and Oliver Smith. Asriel calling out his tag team partner, saying he's got a proposition for him. And here comes, not so bad anymore, this new arena hasn't really walked through the wall at least, but here comes Sean Kent, the brother of the legendary Ryan Kent, of course, who's over on Thursday Night Genesis. Got a big match coming up this Sunday at Point Break against Bison in a number one contenders match for the Alpha World Championship. Here comes Sean Kent, though, willing to hear out Asriel. Let's hear what Asriel's big proposition is for this newcomer, the former two-time international champion, waiting in the ring there. Sean Kent a little miffed at the fans. I'll be honest, I don't have anything better going on right now, so I decided to humor you and hear you out. So here I am, and there you are. There are the people, there's a light, there's the stage. Everything's in place. Indeed it is, Sean Kent. Thank you for pointing out everything in the arena. I didn't know that the stage is over there, so I appreciate him telling me that much, at least. All right, let's see. Asriel going to respond. I think you and I complement each other well. We're like chocolate and peanut butter. Apart, whatever, we're fine. Great, even. Together, though? Together, we can be amazing. So let's make this happen. Let's form a tag team. Asriel offering to join forces with Sean Kent here and form a tag team. Let's see what Kent feels about that proposition. I trust you about as far as I can throw you. And while you may be strong, I'm not a Superman. However, there may indeed be some benefits about forming a tag team together. Fine, I'll form a team with you for now, but I'll be keeping my eye on you. So Sean Kent agreeing to form a tag team. This is a monumentous day. I want everything to mark it down on their calendars. This is the day Sean Kent agreed to form the most dominant, most decorated tag team in CMV history. We're putting the tag team division on notice. We're coming for the tag team championship, and together, nothing can stop us. Don't say we didn't warn you, and partner, you're on notice. I will hesitate to drop you if you can't hang. So Sean Kent agreeing to form a tag team with Asriel here, but warning him that if he can't hang, if he can't, you know, carry his end of this bargain here, then he won't hesitate to drop him. But apparently a new team on the scene here, Asriel and Sean Kent together putting the division on notice, saying they're coming for the tag team titles. What a pairing. They did win last week. I said they worked very, very well together, and I even said during that match they make a great actual tag team. And now it is to be so as we get into the co-main event, my friends, and a tweet from TakeOver going to come our way. Jaquan Shea, before he comes out here, he says, why is it that when I saw what my match, it had to be known as non-title? Because CMV knows who they have on their hands, a true champion. I do believe that every match with the champion is labeled as non-title, with Jaquan Shea just wanting to, of course, fluff his own feathers, as always. He's got his own match this Sunday at Point Break coming up when he battles Nelson Jr. in a no-holds-barred match. But, of course, folks, Chris Andrews set to have that rubber match of the century for that Anarchy Championship against Zach Cage. They've gone back and forth the past 2 months. It all comes to an end this Sunday, and that huge announcement that I've been talking about all night long, Johnny Sampson letting me know that Zach Cage will challenge Chris Andrews for the CMB Anarchy Championship. 30-minute Iron Man match, my friends. That's right. Iron Man match. It will be 30 minutes. The man who gets the most pinfalls or submissions at the end of that time limit will walk out as the rightful CMB Anarchy Champion. Currently, they are both 1-1. When it's all said and done this Sunday, who's going to emerge with the belt around their waist? We're going to find out as Chris Andrews looks for that last bit of momentum heading into that huge matchup, as does Jaquan Shea, though. Really a must-win situation for both men, but only one can snatch up that victory. Oliver Smith, I just said, he was last week. Azra and Sean Kent beat Crow and Oliver Smith. As we get a tweet from The Dream, folks, who says, Rex and his butt buddies are lucky I have a title match this Sunday. I would have walked them up down the stands, beating their asses like I did Bannon. But I have to stay healthy and decided to stay down so I could be 100% for when I start defending my title. So Valentine putting Rex Carter and the real number one Bubba's on notice to watch their backs. But for now, he's got to focus on the Armageddon Hell in a Cell and winning that United States Championship. Co-main event time. Jaquan Shea will be making his pay-per-view debut this Sunday at Point Break. He was at Milestone for the 2-year anniversary. That was a special event, though, over in England. His first pay-per-view will be seen by millions upon millions this Sunday, with his chance to shine over Nelson Jr. And here's a tweet from Bob Luger, guys, towards The Dream. He says, sounds like an excuse. Bob Luger in a foul mood. Usually his tweets are a little bit more elaborate and more jabbing, you know, poking fun at Valentine. Very serious there. The Bloody Brett making this crowd away. He wasn't in action last week, so it's been two long weeks since the Sea of Universe has seen their beloved Anarchy champion, the one and only Bloody Brett himself, Chris Andrews, in his second reign with the title since dethroning Zach Cage, handing him an absolute thrashing, a mollywhopping, you could say, at Milestone. Match lasting no more than 5 minutes. Chris Andrews said, I'm going to Milestone to dish out some revenge, and indeed he did. But this Sunday, he does it. Can he do it again? Well, no doubt it will be longer than 5 minutes. A 30-minute Iron Man match it will be. It's whoever at the end of that time limit has the most decisions will walk out as the Anarchy champion. Zach Cage took a loss last week on the Genesis live event to Jay Davis. So his momentum not looking so great. Let's see if Andrews can keep his running. Referee rings the bell for this co-main event matchup. Big opportunity for Jaquan Shea to put down the Anarchy champion. A non-title matchup could put him in contendership post-Point Break. As now Jaquan just relentlessly going to stomp down onto him. Chris Andrews, though, quickly back to his feet with a jab to the midsection. Oh, I'm going to take him to Suplex City already? God damn, there's one. Gets him up to his feet. Two, Jaquan Shea already rocked the first minute in. And three, Chris Andrews just leave the ring now. Take that count out loss. Arrive Suplex City lead, baby. Let's get that OG Andrews. Oh, big knee straight to the chest. Daquan Shade grabbing him by that little, spear by Andrew Daquan Shade. That caught him off guard. He just take a second. And here's a tweet from Rex Carter, guys, who says, I finally found me some beer. Time to win that United States Championship from Sim Vantine. Oh, big curb stomp to plant Andrew's face first into the canvas. And Jaquan's not done. One of my favorite moves. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, shit. Holy fuck, that counter was deadly, yo. Just about snapped his goddamn neck on that bottom rope. I was excited to see the Hurricanrana DDT, but nah, Andrew said let me kill this kid real quick instead. Now, the two amigos. Usually Andrew loves all things threes, but just two here for that one. Jaquan Shea letting us know that he's not dead, at least not yet. To get a big full Nelson slam, though. And Chris Andrews not even giving him a second to rest. Front headlock making him smell his armpit. What do we got here? An arm trap belly to belly. Chris Andrews, a powerhouse, a brawler. Bloody Brit, the majority, about 90% of his matches, he's busted wide open. We'll see if Jaquan can make sure it happens here tonight or not. Not looking like it right now. Ever since eating that decapitator there in the bottom rope, it's been all Bloody Brit. Just beating JS down. Oh, shooting in for a grapple. I believe Andrews might have been going for the winding British uppercut. If so, that is a clutch counter for Jaquan. Oh, how about a hammer and sickle, though? Taking a quick trip to Russia there. Out onto the ring apron goes Shea. Belly to belly, rips him overhead. Suplex City tonight for fucking Andrews. My God, that's like the fucking eighth suplex he's hit in this match. One, two, just a two count. And here's another tweet from Rex Carter. Guy says, wait, I done one, and it thanks to Bloody Brat's beer stash, he's a true hero. So I guess Britt lending Rex Carter some beer for his match as Jaquan Shea with a shout out to his old stablemate Jamari Williams with some Kiwi Crushers, that final one, right to the back of the head. Jaquan Shea wasting no time telling Britt to get the fuck up. He's not done with him yet. Britt. Sure to be Daisy. Dizzy. Oh, drops him with that Marine Buster. Gonna drag him away with the ropes. Make sure there ain't none of them rope break shenanigans. Jaquan make the steal here. One, two. No, he cannot. Andrew showcasing that heart, that stamina of his. They can just keep going and going. Takes a lot to keep down the Brit. Oh, I thought that. I thought Brit was hitting something, but no, Jaquan with a whirly bird head scissors nearly sends him out of the ring. And now Shea gonna scale to the top rope. Off the top, gonna take the risk with a 450, but it does not pay off, ladies and gentlemen. It's planting face first, chest first, right into the canvas. And now Chris Andrews looking to dish out. No, Jaquan just smacking him off to the side like fuck your shit. And swinging neckbreaker to quickly follow that up. As again he goes to the top rope. 450, oh no, 630 senton he did. And then he got, maybe a fin even, I'm not sure. One, two, just a two count. And Jaquan Shea can hardly believe it, but Chris Andrews can take a hit, and then I guess that was a sig, because now Jaquan, middle of the ring. No, Andrews saying, my head's fucking cracked in enough, thank you. And now paying homage to one of his idols in the British Bulldog with that running power slam. This has been a fast-paced, but non-stop match. I haven't been able to catch my breath since it started, since the bell rang. And there's the winding British uppercut. Just about knocked Jaquan's head up into the cheap seats here tonight in Houston, Texas. And Jaquan got to push Britt off of him, tries for a lateral press, looking to finish. The rope break there, I believe, though. Yeah, I smell good. I know you want to fuck me, Voodoo. Just a minute, baby. Voodoo, baby. Trying for another power slam, perhaps, but no! Jaquan Shea gonna counter with a reverse DDT to save himself. Now he's lifted up back to his feet, taking overhead with that fireman's carry. Now gonna drag him off towards the middle of the ring. Leg drop, that ain't enough though. Elbow drop, still ain't enough. Forearm smash right to the face. Britt just chopping him up, giving him a whirl. Gonna finish it off by putting him in the corner. What's the Britt thinking of here? Oh, we're not gonna find out. Jaquan Shea with that quickness. An elbow to the side of the head backs him up. Britt though counters right out of it into a Russian leg sweep. It's 99-9 up in here, Maury. Oh, we had a reversal fest of what, tip for tat maybe? And now an elbow drop to the inner thigh. Maybe trying to make sure that Jaquan Shea can't go to the top rope again as he hammers away at the side of Jaquan's knee. Now bringing him up to his feet. A second wailing British uppercut. And I think I saw Jaquan's eyes just roll in the back of his head there. I saw the whites. Shea, though, knows what a big opportunity this is to be the win of his career if he can put down the Brit. A former international champion in his second reign as the Anarchy champion. Got an elbow to the back of the midsection. Rolling! Out of nowhere to do it in. One, two, three, and Chris Andrews secures himself the victory. Chris Andrews on the road to his 30-minute Ironman match with Zach Cage this Sunday at Point Break. The Anarchy title on the line to end their back and forth. Going to pick up this crucial momentum victory. What a great matchup, though. No doubt Jaquan Shea putting up one hell of a fight and didn't go down easy. Certainly gave the Bloody Brit a run for his money, but Andrew's going to be standing tall here live on Monday Night Fusion. And there it is out of nowhere with some revenge. Momentous momentum. All right, say that three times fast. That's what Chris Andrews just got here tonight in this matchup, ladies and gentlemen. I sure hope that Zach Cage is watching, because he'll be stuck in the ring for half an hour with that man in just 6 nights' time. And Britt is looking for blood. He's looking for revenge. Excuse me. I'm allergic to Chris Andrews. My bad. Please understand. That guard, James, with a picture of Schmitty's face on his shirt. Oh, it's main event time, my friends. Tag team action. Which we were supposed to be seeing Schmitty team with Xander Slate to battle Paul Devine and Justin Sane here before the show started tonight. We got a CMB.com exclusive peek into Schmitty's locker room. We heard Schmitty saying about how he doesn't want to team with someone like Xander Slate. You know, a phony, a fake, a pushover. And how he's kind of not feeling so great, a little bit under the weather still. So he asked his personal interviewer, his good friend James here, to fill in for him. And James was more than happy. So Schmitty has left, guys. He is no longer in the arena. Who knows if he's even still in the States. He was going to go home and surprise Laura. So his James filling in here for him. And Xander Slate, I'm being told, absolutely livid backstage. Absolutely furious that Schmitty dished him and gave him this schmuck. But Xander realizing that a win over not only Paul Devine, but the champ, the man he will face this Sunday for the title in the same match with his momentum, momentous momentum that he cannot pass up on. So obviously, I think that it's going to be up to him here. I don't think James has any wrestling experience at all. Again, he's an interviewer, Schmitty's personal interviewer. We don't even really know where he came from. He came out of nowhere one week. Schmitty was just tugging him behind. But indeed, yes, we just learned from Schmitty though, who tweeted out confirming, talking with Johnny Sampson, confirming that this Sunday indeed he will go one on one with Paul Devine. And we know that Xander Slate will be challenging Justin Sane for the undisputed World Heavyweight Championship. What up, Zeke, man? Zeke 91, my friend. He's been here a couple of times. He's been in the chat a few times. Certainly the way this month has been going, though, if you were a betting man, Justin Sane is Justin Sane at the end of the day. He's the unpredictable one. He's one of the greatest, if not the greatest, of all time. And you can't count him out anywhere. Anytime, you can't count out Justin Sane. But the way that this month has been going, Xander Slate's been on a bit of a tear, and Justin Sane has been losing left and right 2 weeks in a row. Unheard of for someone like Justin Sane, who... Oh! What? What the fuck was that? What? What? Why did it just disappear for a second there? He was just flying. Okay. As I was saying, Justin Sane losing 2 weeks in a row, last week to Paul Devine and the week prior to Samuel Boone. That's unheard of. Justin Sane, who took no more than 10 losses in all of season three, losing two weeks in a row. And Cole Savage again citing the law of averages that, you know, Justin Sane wins so much that there'll come a time when he has to lose one or two matches. But every excuse under the sun couldn't be enough, you know, for Cole Savage to just explain the shock factor from the Sea of Universe seeing Justin Sane pinned twice in the span of 2 weeks. Well, Xander Slate, fresh off of beating Bannon last week, beat the Kent brothers, Ryan and Sean Kent, 2 days in a row. Xander Slate proving why he deserves this undisputed championship matchup. And there, definitely the tensions have been high. There is a lot of animosity between this man and Justin Sane. They've come to blows multiple times this past month and last month leading up to Validation. Xander Slate has the chance to become a three-time world champion for the first time in over 2 years. Last time he held a world title was before Ascendance 2. Of course, he's the first ever Money in the Bank winner. Xander Slate has thought over these last 2 years he always deserved to be the main event of every single show, of every single pay-per-view. He still thinks that world title is his and that Justin Sane's just keeping it warm for him. And there you have it. Xander Slate, like, standing 3 feet away from James here, who's got a fucking picture of Schmitty's face on his shirt as the Asian sensation, Japan's biggest export, the man who puts the rising and rising sun in the man who beat Justin Sane clean last week, Paul Devine, makes his way out here. And Devine was quick to hop on Twitter and say that he's the rightful number one contender, that he should most definitely be challenging Xander Slater, Justin Sane, whoever walks out of Point Break, the world champion. It's hard to argue. But Paul Devine's got a date with Schmitty this Sunday. Schmitty and Desolation have just torn apart Devine's entire New God stable. Reese Matthews on the shelf. Mike Crimson on the shelf. Sebastian Frost. We don't know if he's injured after that match he had last week in Schmitty, but he's not here tonight. So Paul Devine on his own certainly cannot rely on his partner, Justin Sane. Who knows if they'll even be able to work together long enough here to reach their common goal and get the victory. The four-time tag team champion, Former Anarchy champion has had multiple encounters with Xander Slate over the years here in CMB as well. On pay-per-view, even a couple of times they've come to blows, so they're no strangers. And in fact, Xander Slate and Justin Sane are certainly no strangers. They fought before on pay-per-view. In fact, just last season, it was at Homecoming, the final pay-per-view of 2017 here in CMB. They fought, in which Justin Sane emerged the victor. It was a Cyborg Invitational match many moons ago, though. Who will walk out this Sunday, the world champion? And here he comes. Every single time he makes his way out onto the stage, the shortest send chills up and down my spine and the majority of the CMB universes. The unpredictable one, Justin Sane. The one and only man to hold that title four times. Currently in his fourth month as champion, quickly approaching breaking his own record of 6 months. If he can get past Slate this Sunday. And Justin Sane does not take Xander seriously as a challenger. We've heard him say that multiple times over these past couple of months. He just doesn't take Xander as a serious threat, and that very well may be his downfall come Point Break. Justin Sane has 3 title defenses currently under his belt in his fourth reign. Looking to make it 4 this Sunday. And I think he had 5. I think he had 5 in his second reign. 5 defenses, or it might have been 4. I don't think there's actually any more than 4 for the world championship. In fact, I think it's currently he and Hayden who are tied both at 4 for most defenses with the Undisputed Championship. So again, he'll look to tie another one of his own records if he wins this Sunday. Oh, nice jumping shot right there by Paul Devine to James, who's starting things off, and Devine. You can show the aggression that he's showing early on, and that's because James is no innocent bystander. At Milestone, he joined in on the jumping of Mike Crimson. James himself got a couple of chair shots in on the youngster, the protege of Paul Devine. So the Asian sensation certainly going to get some payback for his stablemate here, as he's wearing fucking socks and sandals in this wrestling match, right? And I can't get over that Schmitty head on his shirt either, as we get a tag to Justin Sane. Poor Jay. I gotta feel bad for him a little bit. But oh my god! Taking a page out of Desolation's book. Oh my god, could this be it already? 1, 2! Oh dear god, Xander Slate floor with a back suplex, fucking side slam by Devine. And now taken out of the ring, eliminated from the Royal Rumble. Devine just taking out the garbage right now. Schmitty leather got a tweet saying, "Make me proud, James," but so far I don't think he is. And Justin Sane just kind of like toying with him a little bit, messing with him, just holding him in that front headlock. And now a single knee facebuster already busted open. Xander's like, just hands and fucking face in his hands, like, dear fucking god, why did I come out here tonight? This is gonna count as a loss on my fucking record now. Oh my god, look at James. That guy's already. Look at Sane, dude, he's killing him. Sane showing no mercy. Dear fucking god, why? Jesus, man. Justin, come on. I know James is a fucking asshole, you know, he's a pal of Schmitty's and everything, but come on, he's just a kid. He's not a wrestler. What's up, J-Rod? Just in time to see this mauling of James right now. Justin Sane just killing him. That crimson mask dawned right now. There's blood dripping down to Schmitty's face, That's got a bro kick from Justin Sane. That's new. Oh, James with a knee to Sane. I'm actually impressed he even got one hit off. And Xander like, fucking kid, if you don't tag me in right now, I'm going to kill you and your entire family. That's going to have to Jeez, good lord. Oh, no! No, Sane! No! Oh, German suplex to James. And Justin Sane pointing up to heaven, I guess. That's where James is going to go after this fucking mauling is over. Not even letting him stand on his feet. Good Christ above God, end this, please. James just trying to roll out of the way at this point. I can't even grapple Sane. Oh my God, you see that knee twerking. You know what's coming next, ladies and gentlemen. It's Justin Sane looking to unleash. I built it up so much. And James with some elbows. Make the tag, make the tag. Yes, Sanders like tagged into this match is saved for now. And Slate now has a chance to put the team on his back and carry out the victory here. Justin Sane with a front headlock, European uppercut, gonna stagger Slate. Justin Sane getting his hands on his challenger this Sunday at Point Break, where that world title will be on the line. Justin Sane spending James spending a total of a minute 30 in the ring. He's already busted wide open. He's fucking beat to all hell. Probably has a concussion, maybe a broken rib, probably a dislocated shoulder. I don't know what Xander just did right there. These two are missing each other horribly right now. Discombobulated is what is Xander Slate going for here. The OG dirty heel with a gourd buster. Gonna make Sane kiss that canvas. Now sizing up Justin Sane, dragging a knee right into Sane's temple. And the show certainly putting one on right now as he looks to do the Sunday Slate walk slam. If he pins Justin Sane, what a momentum boost that would be heading into the pay-per-view. But no, just a two count. Xander not beating around the bush, not wasting any time as he looks for a clean slate on the world champion. A third loss in a row for Sane would be unheard of. Can Xander do it? One, two. Paul Devine makes the save. James trying his damnedest, but couldn't make it there in time. He's already dead. It's pretty much a handicap match at this point. As Xander keeps the assault on Justin Sane, pinning him to the canvas. Now those showboat-esque traits on display by Xander as he taunts and Justin Sane with a kick to the gut for his troubles. The hell is he? Oh my God, they're doing Sane! No, my God, what a DDT. And Sane marking his territory. He is the undisputed champion for a reason, ladies and gentlemen. Irish Whip puts him in the corner. Xander Slate trying to stay on top of things here. Trying to stay in that driver's seat. Sane not going to allow it to happen, though. Oh, he's going to do it again. No, please, Sane, don't do it. Oh, God. DDT off the top rope. And now Sane, he tastes it. He can smell it in the air. Jumping cutter. The painkiller. Justin Sane calls that one, two, just a two count though. Devine failing to spear James off the ring apron. Xander Slate staying alive, but for how long? He virtually has no partner to tag out to. Or if he does, James is going to come in and get killed himself. Oh, and now Sane looking to deliver some of them headbutts, those signature headbutts of his. To Xander here, crack that coconut, looking for some more blood. Xander Slate's lifeless carcass just dragged away from the ropes. And now that arm just trying to tear it out of the socket is Paul Devine. Awesome, more headbutts, and there's the blood, ladies and gentlemen. The blood has been spilled on Xander Slate now. Justin Sane's not even worried about tagging out to Devine here. Bro kick! Oh, Xander Slate saw it coming though. Steps out of the way now from behind. Knee strikes right to the spine and drops him with a reverse DDT. Alexander, what is he looking for here? Shoots down low, a second dose of the slate walk slam. One, two, there's Devine again to make the save. And James just like came in and then said, nah. Takes a big crack right to the jaw. Justin Sane backing up into the corner. I do not like the looks of this. Oh, he's tuning up the band, ladies and gentlemen. Stomping his feet. Looking to shatter. No, Slade again clutching the reversal. Oh, what a reversal by Sane, though. Reverse the reversal, reverse the reverse, tip for tap, back and forth. Maury, 1999. Big old facebreaker launches Xander Slade back as Justin once again, like a beast in the wild, pouncing on his prey with the painkiller. Hooks the leg. One, two. No! Slade kicks out of a second jumping cutter. Dear God, insane in the corner at this point. Like, come on. Come on, guy. You know you're going to lose. Just sit down already. Insane pinning Xander Slate. Xander Slate pinning Sane just six nights ahead of their world title collision. Looking for the clean slate again, but just insane. Gotta get himself out of it. Now lean him up against the ropes. What does Justin Sane have in mind here? I can assure you, whatever it is, it's not gonna be pretty. Forearm smash to the back of the head. Justin Sane, knee right to the temple to knock him back into the ring. Now gonna target that cut. That open wound beginning to bleed more. Justin Sane crouching down, perhaps saying to Xander, I told you, you're not worthy of being in the same ring as me. You do not deserve to challenge me for this championship. And Justin Sane proving that right now with the beating he's given Slate, but Slate, you gotta give him credit, he's not backing down. And now gonna make the tag to James. Xander perhaps saying, fuck this. I'm just going to let James get pinned. You know, he'll take the loss. Whatever. Gets the... Oh! James just punched Sander in the back of the head. And now we're going to take advantage of the distraction. Same with the face buster. One. Two. Three. Oh, just a two count. Dear God. No, oh, the need to wet. Devine, what are you doing? Devine, why? Oh, he's gonna go for it again. He's gonna go for it again. Poor James. The lead to win. One, two, three. This mauling comes to an end. Fucking James just killed. And Xander Slate just backing away from the scene, up the ramp, nursing his head, that nasty gash, as he just washed on as James got his head nearly kneed off the fucking rafters. My God, what a main event. We certainly got a taste of what Xander Slate versus Justin Sane is gonna be like come this Sunday at Point Break. And we certainly learned, without a shadow of a doubt, that James does not belong in the ring. And we're going to get this sick indie camera angle here through the fucking armpit of a fan. As Justin Sane hit a second need to win to pick up the victory. And Justin Sane and Paul Devine. But tensions are high, and we get a handshake between the two. Showing respect. Justin Sane respects any man who can beat him clean. He said that in the past. You beat him clean, you earn his respect. Paul Devine did that last week. And these two men have the upper hand heading into Genesis. Heading into Point Break, I should say. Genesis is this Thursday, but they are not going to be on it. Dogs barking at literally nothing, as always. What's new? And here's a tweet from Schmitty Guys, our final tweet of the night. He says, such a disgusting display. Schmitty. I don't know if he's disgusted with James's performance or with Justin Sane literally killing his friend there, his personal interviewer. What a fusion that was, the real good one. We got a new team between Azrael and Sean Kent formed, putting the tag team division on notice. See if we got anybody who wants to jump in on this commentary. The one that Gumball just got on. The big gummy boy himself. Gummy babe. Where you at, Batman, you little bitch boy? Echo, where the fuck are you? send James to Zach Payne's training camp. Hello?
What's up, bitch?
Don't call me names, please.
Yes, ma'am.
It's a Christian family show.
Dude, fucking James was sick as fuck, man.
Rip James Memorial Battle Royal, the next Ascendance.
You didn't mention the part in the promo where he's like, cool, I'll get my four-wheeler.
I mean, did you see the part where he literally flew down the ramp, though?
No, I didn't see it, but Topher told me about it.
That was a good one.
Fucking James.
Wow, Gumball not going to join us. See how it is. Your cause can join Cross Gaming. If you hit !CMV, !join in the chat, you get a link to our website. Sign up over there. Post your cause name and hashtags on the waiting list. And I'll grab them as soon as I can. I would have got a tag team match.
Can I join, JK? Fucking Tomcat.
What
the fuck
see,
is Gumball, man?
The Hooligans.
He's right here. He can't join in his Xbox app because he's a fucking retard.
Oh, Bobby Sherman and AJ Styles, apparently. Cool. Oh, we got MJ Warrior and Bloody Justice. How about that fucking
boom,
Warrior
boom, pal.
Justice King and Company promo, though? One of my favorites, without a doubt.
Oh, yeah?
Better than anything you could ever write, Batman.
Wow. Dude, I'll have
promo
to
of the year goes to J-Rod, no doubt. You're a great promo, my
See,
friend.
See, I don't even know why I wasn't even nominated for promo of the year for Cop Show. I mean, I was still over there. Fucking promoed more than all of them, dude. Shit, he fucking put Tim on there. Tim hasn't even made a promo.
I know, Tim's nominated for like three fucking things. Eric Matthews, I saw, is nominated for like 10 Grammy Awards.
I said, how come I'm not nominated for anything? He said, you are, voice. I was like, huh? I made one promo for him.
Used pay-per-view attire of who? Who's pay-per-view attire, bitch? Oh, probably Bloody Justice. It's pretty rude, Noah. It's pretty rude.
What's Noah's calls, dude? I keep seeing him talk.
King and Company. Adam Adams.
Oh.
Who's that other guy fighting?
Don't really know.
Oh, Miles Boyd.
Oh. I don't know who King Matt is. I'll have to tune in.
You don't
Genesis.
Know who King Matt is? Wow.
Dude,
Trouble's
my name is Matt. Who's Trouble? He left, remember?
Never. Oh, Punk is not here.
Who's that Chinese guy in Austin?
I was gonna put James in action again.
Go ahead,
we'll
dude.
Get James
I'm not putting
Smith.
No fucking. Dude, he's not even gonna go on your training, J-Rod. He's being trained by Schmitty.
The Bloody Justice training.
You see, Schmitty actually has a lot of friends, and I'm one of them. And he really does not appreciate when people talk about his proteges. See, James really
no,
isn't
Maury.
Just. I'm sorry, what? I was kind of talking, but what?
Go on.
Anyways, yes, he did leave Maury. And, you know, James isn't his personal interviewer. I don't know where you got that idea from, but he's more of a personal assistant, aka best friend. You know, because his former best friend kind of turned on him.
What kind of best friend would let him get killed like that?
Someone who's willing to do it for Schmitty. He knew Schmitty wasn't feeling good.
What do you know? What kind of sickness Schmitty's coming down with? Will he be okay by this Sunday?
Well, have you ever heard of the fluke virus? It runs a lot down in NXT. Ever since he came from there, he couldn't really get it out of his system. You know, sometimes he thinks he has it out of his system, and then sometimes he doesn't. And with his match with Paul Devine, that's when he really knew that he still had symptoms of the fluke virus. So he's still getting that checked in. Yeah, he's getting it checked out and stuff. He should be good. He should be good for Point Break, though.
Oh, fuck. I forgot who Michael Walker's fighting.
Let me check. Man Wolf. Fighting Man Wolf, man.
The fuck up, bitch, and give me the goddamn name.
Alright, hold on. Pussy. I just got punked out, dude. Tyson Cage.
Ah.
Who the fuck is Lance Griffin? Dude, hold on.
Well, a tweet here from Lance Griffin of Genesis. He says, "What is involved in the Schmitty training camp?"
Hey, my name's Ted Dickens, by the way. You see, there is no Schmitty training camp. He just picks and chooses who he wants to share his wisdom with, and he has no interest in training anybody of the likes of you. He really doesn't even know who you are, so maybe get your name known a little bit, and yeah.
Savage. I don't think there's
no,
any mods
dude, don't
the,
even mention Cole
on
Savage
the chat
to me.
Right now.
Schmitty thinks that Cole Savage is a leech.
Orton, are you still here? Oh, there's Gumball.
There you are, pussy. He won't connect.
Gumball, we need you in the chat. We don't have any
He's
mods.
Not gonna connect, dude. He's just gonna fucking like disappear. Make me a mod, pussy. Right.
I can't.
You still don't trust me to this day, do you?
I couldn't even
if
I wanted to.
Is it that, or do you think that if you did, everyone would fucking complain?
Also, I couldn't even hold on to it right now. I have my phone.
You fucking pussy.
I guess we'll have to do it the old way. Just random. Where? Fucking Borton had to go to bed. He's school in the morning.
Here, let me book it.
Alright, let's see.
I'm looking at the Fusion roster right now.
Let's see who we get. John Reese on Genesis. Reese Matthews is injured. Tyson Cage already booked. Les Stewart's on Genesis.
Razor Windu.
Pontarelli. The guy's not
versus
here.
Versus Headhunter.
Shut your goddamn mouth. Mouch.
Want to make out?
I guess we'll do it this way. I got a better idea.
Why the hell would he mod Hellish? Or Topher? You see, me and Dashin, we go way back. Since 2012, thank you. That's like 20 years ago. We've seen things together. I'm a mod next WL now.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. What, bro? I fucking told you. I'm looking at the roster.
Let's do another. I don't know. I just feel like another six-man battle royale.
Dude, that's fucking retarded. Book Sean Kemp versus Mike Miles.
How about you shut your goddamn mouth?
Book Dennis Lewis versus Miles Boyd.
I'll let everyone who's typing right now pick someone. So Hellish, Maury,
Book Desolation.
Topher, Noah, Topher, Maury, Hellish, J-Rod's already got a guy. Oh, there's Gumball.
You fucking pussy. All right, Gumball, who do you want to face Manwolf?
Gumball, get in the chat now. We need a mod to do the winner match. Rip.
You fucking pussy.
Gumball coming back just in time.
Hey, Gumball, you got fucking buried by Adam Adams.
Okay. He Bannon didn't get buried. It was a good match.
Adam Adams beat the shit out of him and made him tap out. Oh,
he made him tap out, and then the match restarted, and he pinned him.
One pin.
A pun kick, though.
Yeah.
Maury and
I mean,
Topher.
Dude, fucking James took, like, five fins, and he kept on going, man.
What a tank James is.
Dude, fucking, that was perfect. Thank
you. Topher, you've been winning every week this entire month. You ain't no trouble.
Topher, want to make out?
Every time Mario wins, it takes fucking 10 hours to goddamn choose someone.
Hold on, checking shit. Crow.
Actually, that says to hit. Really? Hellish already got... Hellish gonna have these back-to-back matches.
Wow, Maury. You didn't check enough.
Wow, Gumball, do it again. Topher forfeits.
Gumball, do it. Let me be it. Wow. Dude,
no,
he's
gonna pick
Rip
Ray. You know that?
Dude, book Bryce Hurt. You never book him.
He's on Genesis.
Yeah, whatever, dude. Hold on, I'm gonna see my tacos.
I don't like
already.
You very much.
Yeah, we can make out later.
Are you choosing Rip Ray? I feel like he is. So, Gumball, how about that weather? What up, Shark Kills, third account? Welcome to the stream, my friend. All right, let's do it. Oh my god, that scared me. What is that? Hey, shush. What the fuck is going on? Now let's see it. Sorry about that. I had to go check my dogs out the window real quick. Alright, let's get this underway. I'm gonna chuck you out the window next. Where's Hurt? Alright, here we go. Kicking off this live event. Gonna have some tag team action coming our way. As the Hooligans will be battling the live event specialists in the Warriors Justice. We're looking for that win after coming off a string of losses this past month. Most recently in the Hotline Miami or Heatline Bling last week. The Hooligans also losing to Eli Richards and Drake Garrett recently. Is that number one contender position still open? Shanaz Andonian, son of Sheik's Fusion Tag Team Tittles. So see if ever who wins here. What? See whoever wins here perhaps will move up in the rankings. Cranberry juice is fucking a foul thing. God. Of course you like cranberry juice. Fucking cretin. You're not gonna correct me and say cretin like you did last time? Oh, here's a tweet from Bloody Justice. He says, "We are alive." It's good to know.
Leave the room.
Welcome back. How are those tacos?
They're not ready yet.
What a shame.
No, I'm here, Topher. I was checking on my tacos. So fucking fun. Dude, what's wrong with that guy's eyes? Is that Bloody Justice?
It's Bloody Justice, yeah. He's got contacts.
Dude, I always like see his promos and his tweets and stuff, but I don't even think I've ever seen him wrestle.
A first time viewing of Bloody Justice.
I'm just kidding. Alright, don't make a fucking big deal out of it.
Wow, alright, let's see how it is. I don't kid around, alright? Take this very seriously.
Dude, my birthday's tomorrow. What are you gonna buy me?
I don't care.
Wow.
My birthday's next Friday. What are you gonna buy me?
Wow. Dude,
I'm not even
going to
invite you to my birthday party.
Badass promo on Genesis for you.
I'm not even going to invite you to go see Triple X with me on my birthday.
Why would you ever go watch that shit movie, dude?
I'm a big Vin Diesel fan.
Really? Did you know he's gay?
I love Triple X. I'm gay for him, so that's good news for me.
Huh. So I bet you're a big Fast and Furious fan, huh?
I love Fast and Furious.
Damn, man. You know what you should watch in the theaters? Passengers. That's an amazing movie. I'm
heard,
a big J-Law
tank
fan.
At the box office?
No, not even close.
I feel like
honestly,
it did terrible.
I think they probably got like trillions of dollars on the first night. Dude, all I'm saying is...
Hey, when did
if
this
you
become
guys want to go
CNB
watch
movie
a kick-ass
hour?
Movie and watch J-Law in action... She's actually pretty sexy in the film, too. Then you want to go watch Passengers.
You're really creeping me out right now.
He woke up. He said, what the hell? He looked around. He seen her. And started making him.
No, everyone. Go see Triple X.
Rugrats,
fuck Passengers. Triple X.
Don't fucking see Triple X. That's stupid.
Everybody go see Triple X. It's going to be a great movie.
Yeah,
watch it with me on my birthday.
Film,
you're all invited
Triple
to the movie
X,
theater.
You gotta be over the age of 18. There's fucking nudity in it. I tried to watch Triple X at school one time, got ISS.
I got OSS.
Gumball, turn your fucking TV down. Wow.
You seem real upset. What did I do to hurt
show.
You?
You trash.
I only love
promo.
You, Gumball.
Dude, you fucking trashed this
person. I just asked a legitimate question. It was you and Batman.
Me?
Or you and Batman. You and Cop.
Me?
Who spammed it?
No, Cop was spamming it first. And then
I was
I
genuinely
Cop.
Curious if Bannon could do something like that on a cold night in Scope.
No, you wasn't. You didn't care. We're actually setting something up, thank you. And he did it perfectly.
Oh, were you?
Yeah. You know, you're talking to a promo genius here.
I'd read a
Topher,
Bloody Justice promo
realized,
any
man.
Day over yours.
Topher, me and you have never feuded or promoed together. Got stuff.
That's not true. There was the Elimination Chamber promo.
No.
Yeah, Billy Weaver for St. Andrews.
Fucking Billy literally just walked out, didn't even say anything, just started pumping. Like, he's still wasn't even talking. I got soap in the sun.
CMV will get a straight to DVD movie. Starring Schmitty.
Hayden. Wow.
Is that when Schmitty gets his movie star gimmick for his straight to DVD film?
I mean, Schmitty is. I messaged Crazy. He didn't message me back. I guess it upset him. I said, how does it feel that Schmitty's already more relevant than Cole Savage? Guess he just couldn't handle it, you know?
I wonder how he feels about Austin getting his hopes up about bringing in a new call and then realizing it's on my show. He probably hates it.
Yeah, I seen that. I thought it was kind of cool. What's his name? Filth?
Shane Scott. You don't remember him?
What? How the fuck would I remember him?
It's his call from way back when.
I showed up.
Remember Bunka did that little call video thing he used to do way back when for a little bit.
You mean Twisted's Call Universe?
No, it was Bunka. He did it in WCF. He took people's calls and just did like little videos.
I wasn't even.
Yeah, he was in that.
I didn't really do any. I didn't participate or read up any of it, so.
Well, this matchup is about to get underway. As it'll be Bobby Sherman and MJ Warrior kicking things off. Clean break there.
A Hawaiian t-shirt. Khaki shorts. Socks with sandals.
Puma. Fucking Puma. Fucking shoes, dude.
No.
He wears a visor as well. That's a good tag. And speaking of Bloody Justice, some team Warrior Justice with a double Russian leg sweep. Warriors Justice needing that big win here tonight. Both these teams desperate for a victory. They've been taking a lot of losses since the start of the season.
Hey, what month are we in? Like, what's the date in universe?
September, CMV time.
Okay.
That's why next month, October, we're going to get the spooky, scary pay-per-view special, Dark Carnival.
Yeah, that's cool. Anyways.
Oh, look at that military press.
January 13.
Look at it.
2019. Schmitty is bringing Bison in the court. I just got it confirmed.
Oh, January. That's a while off.
Yeah. Schmitty said he was going to be a little busy, carrying the brand and stuff.
New year. That'll be on the road to the 5th annual Royal Rumble match.
Yeah. Yeah. They might be able to face up again.
He's going to knee down into the kidney there. Of old boy Bloody Justice gonna get the
Can't
quick tag here.
To be dehorned.
To be dehorned. Chef Schmitty with the case. Come back the following week with wearing Bison's mask. He's got the horns on.
No, why would he do that? He'd be a hypocrite. I'm starting to think you're just not that good.
I don't know what Bobby Sherman's doing right here. Oh, there we go. Back suplex and a takedown, BJ.
Hey, what's that tag team's name?
Which one?
Not J-Rod's.
Hooligans.
Hooligans. I like them. They look cool.
The big fan is Batman of the Hooligans here.
Get See, I just said
Bloody
I like
Justice
them.
In the corner. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh, that's a regular attack. Thought maybe they tried to finish here.
King's Company.
King and Company guy. Oh, double shoulder block tries for the pin, but Sherman breaking up his own partner's.
They're no atonement.
Oh, they are no atonement. Remember when MJ Warrior was a part of that?
Yeah, man. That was like the greatest stable that has ever lasted 2 weeks, man.
I'd have to say that the tag team between Jay Davis and Troy Mars is probably a better one there. I don't remember
Rebels,
their tag team name.
The Rebels.
Rebels.
We're rebelling.
Watch like how rebellious hands. We are.
We're so rebellious. We like to talk.
Forearm smashed by MJ Warrior, who's not the legal man. Irish whip off the ropes he goes. Oh, knee to the face, gonna break MJ Warrior free. Taking a big old knee strike to the gut there as Will Williamson, double W now, spun around. Irish whip puts him in the corner. And what's Warrior going for here now? Gonna spin him around. Irish whip's the opposite corner. Million miles a minute here. Charged him full force. What a clothesline. Nearly taking his head off as he collapses down into the canvas. MJ Warrior now gonna stomp down. His arm flops him over onto his stomach. What do we got here? Curb stomp from Warrior. It's a first from him. I've never seen him do that before. Look to immediately follow it up. Put him in the corner. This could be a big win for Warrior's Justice. They very much need the boost momentum. I don't remember what their tag fin is. What we got here? Three! Hooks the leg, looking to finish. The referee has to take a big old whirl around, though. And that's going to cost him. Sherman's able to break up the pin. Hey, Batman, nice dog you got there. Tag to Sherman now. Williamson not done, though. Back suplex, gonna set up BJ in position for Sherman to cover. One, two, no, not even a two count. Trying to go for a suplex here in MJ Warrior. We're gonna get out of it though. Belly to belly, this tag team match breaking it all out war. He's gonna knife edge chop, gonna put Sherman in the corner. What we got here? Snake Eyes, keeping it classic as Bloody Justice. As now he's looking for that falling power bomb. Yes, he is. Perhaps going to try for the pin. Oh, he's not. Williamson's still in the fucking ring. Surprise. Good thing the referee doesn't start counting when you're down. Otherwise, that would have been a disqualification right there. Get a boot to the side of the head. MJ Warrior just got, I don't know what's going on right now. Williamson's about to get himself counted out, though, in about a second, I think. Yep, okay. Oh, so close. Clutching up that save as Bloody Justice trying to get out of this neck crank. Irish whip puts Sherman in the corner. Are we in the distance of 3D perhaps? I think we are. And here's the catapult right into the clutches of MJ Warrior, who makes him taste the canvas. The ref is actually goes, no, he's got to take that big loop around again. One, two, three, and Warrior's Justice going to get this tag win. Hey, Batman. Hey, kid. Fucking goddamn dog. What up, Kenji? Just in time to see this tag match come to an end. As Warrior's Justice get a much-needed victory, putting down the hooligans. I think Batman's fucking killing his dog. And there's the finish, a second 3D. Going to see the victory brought to Bloody Justice and MJ Warrior. Would you be happy if I gave every tag team that winning animation, Topher? Coming up next, the lads and gents, we have the debut of the newest acquisition of Monday Night Fusion. Miles Boyd going to be in action as he's set to come toe-to-toe with James Smith, who of course is joined by Dirty Dennis Lewis. James Smith been impressive in his career thus far since debuting at the top of the month. I don't think he's lost yet. He picked up that tag, went alongside Dennis Lewis in his debut. He defeated Rip Ray And I'm pretty sure got another singles win last week at some point. Dennis Lewis, though, coming off that loss against Rip Ray just last week afterwards, offering a handshake to Rip Ray, but Rip Ray denying it, kind of like just giving he and James Smith a dirty look and leaving the ring. Rip Ray in action a little bit later on in the main event, battling Crow.
The beta James of CMB.
Still to come as well. We've got Michael Walker returning, making his successful debut last week, putting down Troy Myers. Tonight, he will take on Tyson Cage. Try to hand Tyson Cage his first loss. He's currently 2-3-0, I do believe. Do you, Noah? Just promo as him, Noah. Or just don't.
Who's Noah? Who's his calls?
I just closed it myself there.
Wow, just gonna ignore me?
Yeah, I don't really like you.
Oh.
Miles Boyd certainly has a fierce look about him, though. Excited to see him in action.
Yeah, it's because he morphed his eyebrows down closer to his eyes.
Is that what happened there?
Yeah.
What about James Smith? What do you think he's looking at? Got quite a worried look on his eyes there.
Hold on.
He doesn't have index fingers either.
That guy with the blonde hair beside him kind of looks like Lucifer from Supernatural.
From Supernatural? Yeah, a little bit. Maybe he is Lucifer. Dun, dun, dun. Some crunchy tacos right there.
Damn.
Oh, Miles Boyd.
Just got punked out.
Damn. Miles Boyd borrowing one of those magical gems from Warriors Justice as he makes his entrance here. His first appearance in CMV. Gumball, you just gonna take that? I think Gumball's killed himself. But Gumball, are you still here though? Because Bloody Justice just answered your fan question. Bloody Justice apparently, when he's not in the ring, likes to wear jeans and a tank top, aka a wife beater, but he doesn't beat his wife. He loves her very much. Just in case anybody was wondering. As James Smith looking to show no mercy on a newcomer. Still fresh to CMV himself, looking to rack up those wins, stay undefeated. Parker hands out the free gems. Here we go. Miles Boyd making his debut. Will it be a successful one, though, as he looks to take down James Smith, the SoCal bad boy. Right out of the gate, looking for a scoop slam type maneuver. Miles Boyd going to deflect that, though. Brings him face first into the canvas, grabbing him by the arm there. Now lifting him high up into the air, grabbing him by the tights, boom, right down to the mat. With a reverse DDT as Dirty Dennis Lewis ringside by his name. You couldn't guess a dirty, dirty heel. Hopefully doesn't interfere in this matchup, or at least not too much, as right out of the gate. Miles Boyd taking a big risk with a 630 senton. That does not pay off. James Smith rolling out of the way, grabbing him in a head scissors now, but Boyd gonna slip through there, break free.
Oh,
nice tattoo.
When I pick up one of my tacos, I'm gonna eat it, right? Now I start watching something, and I tilt it a little bit, and all the meat falls out.
That's a tragic end. Sorry to hear that.
Dude, I bet you'd start cutting yourself if that happened to you.
That taco, Memorial Battle Royal, the next ascendance. As James Smith nearly thrown clean out of the ring with that modified monkey flip, and there's the dirty one. Distracting ringside allows Smith to capitalize from behind with an atomic drop knee right up the asshole. As now it grabs him by the hair in his head, brings him up to his feet. Irish whip, hard Irish whip, sends him right over the top rope, eliminated from the Royal Rumble. And I'm ramming him right into that announce table. James Smith taking it so easy here with this young blood. Beating the shit out of him right now. My goodness. He's got an agenda against him or something. A serious problem. What did this kid do to him? Dennis Lewis watching closely but keeping his distance. Doesn't want to risk a disqualification. As we got a neck crank extension. Referee John Conner at a count of five here, folks. Six now. Miles Boyd gonna lose via count out on his debut. Big near the side of the head, just killing him as Smith right now. What did Boyd do? Fuck his sister or something? My God. Going in. Boyd's had enough though. Finally with a sign of life. And right back to the top rope. Our first look at this kid. First couple minutes we're seeing him in action. You already tell he's a risk taker, a high flyer. Taking too much time to taunt here though, and that might come back to bite him. Off the top rope. Oh, what a drop kick. Nearly put his boots right through Smith's chest. And guys, you're not going to believe this. You like that authentic Schmitty shirt that James wore on Fusion? You can buy it now on CMBShop.com for only $24.99. Get your Schmitty shirts now, folks, before they run out, because they will fast. I'm going to buy them all.
I got mine.
As Miles Boyd with a nice whirly bird head scissors there to take down Smith.
Schmitty sent a couple to Bloody Brit's house.
Big to the jaw there, followed up by a zigzag. As Boyd going to show Dennis Lewis his ass, not falling for the distraction again. Grabbing him by that chrome dome with eyes to finish, but no, stalls the suplex attempt. Whatever Boyd was going for there, we're not going to find out. James saving himself, goes for a knee to the spine now. Boyd moves out of the way though. He saw that coming, charged him, eats a spine buster for his troubles. What a matchup.
Wow, Topher.
Topher, wow. Now a stomp into the gut. Oh, James Smith.
And the payment and
all the way from SoCal with that curb stomp. And that might be enough. One, two, three. No, what?
Who's that bald guy?
Miles Boyd. 2.99999999999. Able to kick out. That is James Smith, who's scaling to the top rope. Looking to stay in the driver's seat, taking a risk of his own with that fish drop right to the chest. Miles Boyd putting his heart on display there. Kick out of that curb stomp, just barely though. He's trying to turn the tides. James Smith not making it easy for him. Out of the front headlock, a trio
damn,
of knee strikes.
Taking them shots.
Now snap there by Miles.
Shots.
Still to come up next. Michael Walker back in action. He'll be taking on old
dude,
boy Tyson Cage.
He died
we'll
in a car
Cage
crash.
Can remain. We'll see if Cage can remain undefeated. If Miles Boyd will pick up another. Miles Boyd. See if Miles Boyd can win here. Michael Walker, I should say. Will pick up another win. As Boyd himself with a little bit of lockjaw. Oh, but there's Dennis Lewis immediately seeing that his boy's in trouble. Calling Boyd's attention. Distracting him long enough for Smith to get back to his feet. Kick to the gut now. Miles Boyd! Sit out suplex powerbomb. Oh my God, that might be enough to do the deed here. Oh, but look at Dennis Lewis, the dirty one, distracting the referee now.
You mean Dennis Miller?
Miles Boyd. Forced to release the hold as Boyd tries to stay in control. He's not happy about what's going on here. The numbers game coming back to bite him. Referee still not ejecting Dennis Lewis though. He misses the springboard. It's okay. It's his first match. He deserves a botch or two.
Fucking bloody
trying
guesses.
To shake off the cobwebs. Smith is still sleeping on his feet, though. There's another trio of knee strikes out of this front headlock. Also to come tonight, guys, Crow. Going to be going one-on-one with Rip Ray. Rip Ray, who knows that man in the ring pretty well as Dennis Lewis ringside. Dennis Lewis and James Lewis trying to induct him into their little stable of friends last week after Rip Ray defeated Lewis in singles action, but turning them down did Rip Ray. As we get it taken over head with that fireman's carry. Boyd takes him down to the canvas. Snapping that arm, lateral press, one, two, just a two count. Leg drop, elbow drop, forearm smash. You good, Batman? Springboard 450 by Miles Boyd. Dennis Lewis just taking out his iPod and blasting this music right now, trying to distract Miles further. But it doesn't seem to be working, so he goes over and grabs a steel chair, which he just put James neck first onto. That was a bad move. As now Boyd with a dragon suplex looking to finish. One, two. No, just a two count. Dennis Lewis nearly screwing his own partner over by bringing in that steel chair. As Boyd trying to keep up the attack. Off the second turnbuckle. What's he looking for here? Oh, going for a moonsault of some kind. Stepping out of the way, though. Smith with a front headlock cinched in. Knee strike connects. And now Smith a second time with the curb stomp all the way from SoCal. Straight into the pin. The distraction going to pay off. One, two, three. And James Smith gets the win. The numbers game too much for Miles Boyd to handle here tonight. You got to think that without Dennis Lewis ringside, Miles Boyd very well may have walked out the victor tonight after hitting that suplex powerbomb early on. We'll never know, though, thanks to the Dirty Ones tactics ringside. No, Borton, you lost. In fact, you died a fiery death.
Borton, you lost so bad, no one even likes you anymore.
Borton, you lost so bad, I deleted your call. That's how bad you lost, kid.
Borton, you lost Borton, so bad, you lost so bad. We're all lactose intolerant now.
You lost so bad, I deleted your account from the site, because don't even bother coming back.
Yeah, bud.
And there was a finish second curb stomp from SoCal by James Smith. Keeps him undefeated. An impressive run by this young man thus far. Gotta give credit to Dennis Lewis for this one, though.
What a scrub. Scrub-a-dub-dub-dub. It's nice knowing you.
Bye now.
Goodbye now.
Sorry, Borton. You're going to have to go to a TCW or a Dragon House. You're not welcome here anymore. As we get into our next matchup of the evening, a couple of more young bloods going at it. Both currently undefeated. Michael Walker only 1-0, made his debut last week where they went over Troy Myers. Tyson Cage, I believe 2-0 he is right now. Might be 3-0. I'm going to say 2-0, though. We're going to make it 3-0. Instead of come, of course, Crow. Looking to bounce back from his recent series of losses, taking on Rip Ray.
Fucking Tyson Cage looks retarded.
How can you not love that beard?
Bro,
that beard is
that's
the greatest thing. You think it's a tattoo?
Yeah. Fucking retard. Yeah, now you feel stupid, don't
you? What are you, fucking dumb?
You're like,
it's not a tattoo.
This is a
beard.
At one point in time.
He just shaves it to look like a cool guy. He goes to the barber, and the barber says, what you want? He says, fuck me up, fam. The barber goes to work, you know?
Shut the
You didn't think I'd hit you with that barber meme, did you? But I did.
Damn, dude. You got me.
Punked out.
Well, you got me. And you're no punk out champion of the world. Dashing DJ, you're free.
Cody Rod S.
Brad.
As
Matt
Michael
Ox.
Walker with this dank entrance intro.
What, is he coming out crashing?
Makes his way out here. I'm already a big fan of this kid. I do like his attire more. Got a pretty dominant win over Torrey Myers as well last week. Wasn't a very long match. I'm going to look to do the same to Tyson Cage here tonight.
Justice tweet. What did you just say, King? That's it. I had respect for you, but you just crossed the line, and now my son is sad. You want to go bring it on, you sob?
Son of a bitch, Evie.
What attire? Hey, what attire am I looking for?
Do you like the tire? What do you think about this tire?
What's wrong? I don't know who's who.
Yeah, Borton, go back to your patty, kid. You fucking fucking scrub, dude.
Oh,
and here comes
Superman
Tyson Cage.
Wow, now I gotta change
the
my
free-spirited, exotic. Superstar looking to remain undefeated here tonight.
All these guys are undefeated, but they've never faced Schmitty, you know?
Well, then they'd still remain undefeated.
Oh, you think so? They like to talk a lot of shit, don't you? But at the end of the day, I don't see you in that ring. Ever.
You see, at the end of the day, the fact of the matter is that I just better than you.
My name is Blue McIntyre. My name is Certified G. I'm a bona fide stud. Bada boom. How you doing?
My name is Drew McIntyre. And I am to be taken seriously. Alvis was actually in here. I don't know if you saw him. He came with like 5 seconds and left. You fucking missed him, Batman. He came in here just for you.
I was in there, dude. I was fucking talking to him, I think.
I don't think you were. You're a liar.
Yeah, we were talking for a little while about cupcakes.
Here we go. Referee rings that bell. Who's going to remain undefeated? Who's going to be handed their first loss?
One of these guys.
Right out of the gate with a nice suplex. Michinoku driver, rather, I should say. And what are these guys?
I said one of these guys.
I believe they're
retard. They're
human beings
of
the planet Earth.
I said one of these guys. Huh. You're a commentator, but you don't listen. Huh.
Right out of the ring, these two spill early on as the referee begins his count. Tyson Cage hammering right at the back of Michael Walker's head. Floor with a loop dice press. Not as quite as good as Xander Slate, but...
Dude, that man's name isn't even Michael.
Dude, what is he related to, Paul?
Dude!
He's taking down with that
what
shoulder
the
block.
Hell?
And Tyson Cage standing at the bottom of the ramp with his arms wide open saying this is his house. Michael Walker, an intruder. As he's taking over his shoulders. Oh, torture rack, neck breaker on the outside at a count of 6 currently. 7 now by the referee. We're going to get a count out here between these
8.
Two.
9.
These two acting as if they've got 10. Something against each other. Oh, there we go. Walker saves the day. I'm going to bring both men back into the ring. This matchup continues. Knife edge chop. Echoing around the arena. Tyson Kidd's going to fire back with a punch. Taking over his shoulders. Oh, single knee gut bust. That's not all, though. Follows it up with a mighty senton.
Alright, I'm taking song requests, guys.
As now Tyson Gage chilling out in the corner, nonchalant, not taking this encounter too seriously, not taking Michael Walker too seriously. Will that be a mistake? Because he's lifted back to his feet. Irish whip now by Tyson, puts him in the corner. Irish whip right back to the other corner. Now going to charge him full force with a wicked lariat. Grabbing him by that long hair of his. Oh, what a punch. Walker not staying down for very long. Tries to shoot in for a belly-to-belly. Takes it over to the top of the head. Ducks the clothesline. Takes one of his own. What a back and forth between these two newcomers. Lateral press by Tyson Cage. Not even a two count, though. Pretty close. Forearm smash to the back of the head. And again, Tyson Cage in the corner. Acting as if this ain't no thing but a chicken wing. As he comes back out, back suplex to connect.
Huh. I didn't know any of you guys was J-Rod. Huh. Weird.
Lifting up to his feet. Tyson Cage! What's he got in store here? Oh! Michael Walker clutching it up to reverse at the very last second there. And now Walker. What is he going to try for here to solve? Oh, trouble in paradise indeed!
Boy, how come you put wrinkles on that all of your guys' foreheads? I've seen you try to put it on Rex Carter.
Oh, my God, Tyson Cage. You can just see the whites of his eyes right now. He might not know where he is. Trying to use the ropes to get back up to his feet. Now he's got a torture rack again into the neck breaker. Dragula.
Hey, listen, this is Dragula.
Lateral press. One. Two. Just a two count now. Tyson Cage. He's going to go into the corner a third time in this match. And taunt again. That's going to end up being his downfall, his ego getting the better of him here. Not taking Walker as a serious threat. Now a seatbelt suplex drops him right on the top of his head. Stomped down onto his face now. Grabbing by the hair. Michael, though, the arm drag brings him back down to earth. Grabbing him by that unique mustache of his. Unique mustache and beard, rather. As he, oh, what a slap to the chest. What the hell is this? What the hell is this? Tyson Cage. Oh my God! Double knee from the sternum. No! What a maneuver by Walker. One, two. Oh, just a two count though. That was a nasty move.
Go the by fuck Michael to bed, Walker J-Rod. There.
That I'm surprised was not enough to get the job done. Tyson Cage trying to fight back to his feet. Now those ribs have got to be hurting him. But he's staying at it. He's going to try again for his signature. Taking it back to 1916. No, reversed again by Walker, who's got that move scouted. He's got Tyson Cage's number. And now Walker with a fisherman's driver. Dropping Tyson right down onto his head. Cage is taunting his ego in this match. Has been his downfall, as now Walker gonna look to finish things off here in this matchup. Dragging away from the ropes, gonna try to pin perhaps. Yes, he is, a little bit late.
Hit him with that.
One, two,
diving
just
elbow,
a
two pile driver.
Oh, Tyson Cage taking a breather, rolling out of the ring, but getting right back in. And gonna catch the Shiranui into the pin. One, two, three, and Michael Walker with another successful matchup here in CMV. Great ending there. Tyson Cage trying to take a quick breather, but it ended up coming back to bite him as soon as he rolls in, gets caught with that Shiranui, and Tyson Cage handed his first loss here at the hands of Michael Walker. Great matchup, though.
Does that M stand for Michael?
I reckon the gas. What a match. Look at that kick. Okay.
How do you feel about Rex Carter winning the U.S. title on Fusion?
And here's the finish. Shiranui, wow. As soon as Tyson Cage gets back in the
just
ring.
Just going to ignore me.
Caught off guard.
Wow.
Wow, 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 wow. Wow. W-O-W.
This kid is impressive, and I see a bright future ahead of him as we get into our final matchup of the stream. Crow going to go one-on-one with Rip Ray.
Dude, Cop almost got fucking snapped on by Tomcat. Dude, Cop, you better say hi to Tomcat quick. He's gonna tell you to suck a dick with cum all over it.
You'll be on Tomcat's shit list.
Yeah, I'm on his shit list.
You don't want to get on that.
I think just because I killed two of my calls because of him.
Don't you have him blocked?
Nah, I unblocked him because he was being funny one day. But now he's kind of not funny.
Damn. Certainly a big opportunity for Rip Ray coming off a victory last week to Dennis Lewis. Again, post-match Dennis Lewis and James Smith offering him a spot on their little group of friends, of course, the Misfits on Genesis as well, led by Monroe.
Hey, you know
but
what
Rip
I noticed?
Rip Ray turning them down, kind of spitting in their face.
Respond.
And got a big opportunity tonight as he takes on the... seasoned, I guess. Seasoned competitor in Crow. What's that? What, my commentary, compadre?
I'm Ted Dickens, and, oh, a lot of people don't even fucking do face morphing, dude. They just move their eyebrows, and that's it. Like, look at that. They got the same nose, same mouth.
I don't know what this
force,
this face morphing is that you're talking about. I'm not familiar.
Dude, you're gonna piss me off. What do you mean you know? You did it with fucking Xander Slate. Oh no, you went the lazy route. Just fucking plastered a random ass face on him.
Not too sure. Here he comes, Crow.
I don't think I know what you're speaking about.
Coming off of a string of losses, most recently a tag team matchup on last week's Reality Wrestling. And, of course, also failing to qualify for the Armageddon Hell in a Cell, losing to Lex Knight. Crow needs a win to get him back in shape, get some momentum back on his side. But the newcomer in Rip Ray not looking to slow his roll.
Who?
Who?
Dude, it says right here, Triple X is the worst movie in history. Do not watch if you want your vision.
Everybody go see Triple X on January the 20th for my birthday.
Everyone just, right now, just go fucking watch Passengers before it goes out.
And here's a tweet, guys, from Bloody Justice. He says, Crow is okay, just not all of what I expected. J-Rod, not a big J-Rod, a.k.a. Bloody Justice, for those who are intimate with him, you know. Apparently not a big fan of Crow here. As out comes Rip Ray, the Youngblood. Looking to keep up his success. I'm a big fan of this guy. I like his look. I like the way he moves in the ring.
God damn it.
You see bright things ahead for him as well. That's trash. Are you sure it's not in one of your tacos?
Hey, Cop, I blocked you again, dude. Because you were talking shit. Let's go for 3 months this time.
Here we go, final matchup of the stream. Can Crow bounce back from this losing streak he's been on? Ray, keep his winning ways alive. Referee rings that bell, and here we go, right out of the gate. Rip Ray charging Crow, taking him down with a wheelbarrow arm drag.
Love how I made that a thing. Rip, tell J-Rod to go the
Rip
fuck
Ray, Rip Ray, a bigger man, not tall, but certainly more masculine. We're expecting him to move like that. He's moving like a cruiserweight across the ring.
He's too busy headbanging to Rob Zombie right now, Headless.
Did you see my 2-year anniversary post for J-Rod? I said, go the fuck to bit.
Oh, did you? I think I only read mine when you said that I carried the company. Then you didn't say anything
for
Echo.
Those were the exact words.
It was really odd.
I did. I said, thank you, Rifted, for bringing us your beautiful brother, Echo. fucking read it, pussy.
I mean, you didn't thank me for bringing Bryce.
Has now ripped Ray with a nice center. This kid impresses me. Like I said, you don't look at him and think maybe a high flyer, a risk taker. I would see maybe a brawler, but Crow certainly is. Likes to throw hands as he takes down Rip Ray in a big old senton using his body weight to crush them ribs. Flops him onto his stomach. Crow grabbing him by the hair on his head. That ponytail going to take a big old knee straight to the face for his troubles. I thabked, rifted.
Thabk.
Oh! Close hand punch right to the chest. Blob.
You didn't even think
clobbering blow. I did think 10.
Oh, did you? I don't even think I read the post, dude.
Wow. Should have made it a universal post.
What do you mean?
As Crow now. Make it a universal post that'll show up in every single thread.
Hold on, man. I'm just going to watch my global title match real quick.
Oh, stomp down onto the shin. Moves out of the way, though. Irish whip now into the corner goes Crow. Rip Ray closing in on him. Takes him down. This Crow, though, with an elbow to the shoulder. Now a kick to the midsection. Lifts him high up into the air. Oh, that was going to be a package pile driver. Powerbomb instead. Grabbing him by that ponytail as well. Into a lateral press. What the fuck are you watching?
My match.
Oh, shit out, powerbomb. Cop suddenly turned into a black man, it seems. It's about time. Oh, crotch chop by Rip Ray, showing that disrespect towards Crow. As now we get an Irish whip, double R off the ropes, rebounds right into a wicked spine buster. Straight into the pin, make sure to hook that leg. Could this be it? One, two, no, just a two count for Crow as he looks to stay in control, though. Right back to the attack, goes for a punch to the temple. Back to his feet is Rip Ray, though, countering with an upper to the midsection. Ray Northern Light Suplex, we know him, though. That's not to finish off the combo. Lifts him high up in the air. Deadlifting him. Look at that strength for a brainbuster. And now to the corner he goes. Looking for a little bit of black magic as he hops right over Crow's head. Oh, looks to bop him in the back, but Crow says, nah. Connects with a kick to the midsection. Shoots slow. What a DDT by Rip Ray. And now Rip Ray going to try for it. Again, immediately wasting no time. As Crow once more falls down onto his knees. And Rip Ray, this time he's going to get it. The heel of his boot just driving right into the base of Crow's skull. As Rip Ray now just trying to size up Crow and soften him up a little bit more as he looks to finish. Charging up the finisher. Scoops him up. Crow jumps down behind, though. Neckbreaker. That's perfect position if Crow can go to the top rope. I don't know if he's, maybe he doesn't have it. Instead, going to go for a kick to the midsection. Another
hey,
package
kind of
powerbomb, perhaps.
Profile picture, man.
I don't know.
Is that a Roman Reigns shirt? Or is that same ass fucking Big Show shirt?
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. To the top. Oh, he's trying for the Swanton Bomb, but Rip Ray begins to get up, and that's gonna take him off as he plants him right back down to the canvas. Crow telling him to stay put as he goes to the top again, and this time gonna fly with the Swanton Bomb into the pin. One, two, no, just
three.
A two count though, and Crow doesn't know what to make of this. Down on one knee, panting heavily, he's tired. Dodges a stomp down to Rip Ray's chest. A little bit pissed off here. Not too happy.
Yeah, I like Rip Ray's attire.
Oh, Rip Ray going to battle back. Trying to stay alive.
Well, they're going to call me a big fan.
Stay alive. Oh, and a stomp down onto the fest. The fest? What is a fest? Dropkick to the temple, though. Rip Ray off the rope.
Now.
Oh,
goodbye
elbow
now.
Drop. Rip Ray arms out wide. Arm drag, Rip Ray down on one knee. Oh, and a forearm smash right to the spine. I don't think you're dumb, Tomcat. I think you're a swell guy. Knuckle sandwich. Cinched in here on Rip Ray. He's having none of it, though. Battles back. Crow catching him with a jawbreaker. Shoots low for the bangarang. Looking to finish off of that. Hooks the leg. One, two, three. And Crow picking up the victory over Rip Ray here tonight. What a matchup to cap off the stream. Crow getting back to his winning ways with a sweet looking bangarang. Rip Ray certainly putting up one hell of a fight. Surprised it wasn't over after this Swanton Bomb here. Showing that resiliency. But look at that, planting him face first. And that would be enough to get the job done. Damn, Tomcat punking you out. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. As always, thank you for joining me. If you like what you saw, you're new to the show, make sure you follow me. If you want to be a part of CMV, you can hit !CMV! Join in the chat to get a link to our website where you can put your call on the waiting list and we will grab them as soon as we can. If you're just content to watch, then so be it. If you want to watch all of our past episodes, check out my YouTube channel, which is linked on my Twitch info page. And I will see you guys on Thursday for the Go Home Show for this Sunday's Point Break pay-per-view.